Good evening, good morning, good afternoon. Welcome. So we are doing some more Angels with Scaly Wings. It's going to be awesome. We're going to be doing the delivery boy this time, which should be fucking interesting. There is apparently more to this character than meets the eye. However, I do not know what that yet means. So I am quite interested to see what we're going to get out of this character. So, we're going to go straight to the game. As usual, this stream is sponsored by Bryce's diary, I mean chocolate milk. Come on. Angels with Scaly Wings, come on. Get on the screen. Bitch, there you go. Okay. So the sun is rising a little bit. We have Bryce over here and, of course, Dean. So we are going to once again continue our journey. Chapter 1. Duty. You make it sound like he is a transformer? Transformers! Robots in disguise. Yes, I know all of this. Habit-a-hap, I've seen before it, and now! Let me see, we're going to shake this guy's hand. We're going to, he forgot the gal- Oh, fuck! I forgot the gallery! Hang on! Excuse me, gallery. Ooh. Ugh. He's wounded! No! Okay, so that's the gallery. Okay. I mean, yeah. Cool. Okay. Make a save check quickly. Exactly. You fuckers. You didn't warn me! I bet he'd win if I was mine, though. Ha! Okay, well, yeah, we'll give her our blood, whatever. Sure, yes I did. Skip. No. Wasn't all that interesting? I mean, yeah, it's a piece of artwork, but you know, it's nothing more than that. Let's just take the copy. Not sure. Shoot? No. Thanks. That light always makes me laugh. Okay, there he is. Did you give it to her? Okay, I need to go to the kitchen. I need to look in the pantry. Lemon. Well, what'd you expect? It does that. I think I'm alright. Does that shit. Hope so. Let me see. I guess I just do the things as usual, you know, do the investigations, etc., etc. Or wait, can I actually skip those or not? Now I want to know. Can I skip those? I mean, there is an achievement where I have to turn him down like 99 times. I mean, that's going to be a fun achievement to get. Because from what I've seen in the game, you know, those investigations are kind of, you know, a necessary part of the plot. Decline 99 times. I mean, how the fuck am I gonna do that? With achievement, yes, that I know. I know how to get the achievement, it kind of explains itself. But can I skip them is what I want to know. Okay, take it too long, whatever. Just use the tab? Okay. Oh, skipping now you can't anymore. Okay. Okay, so we were doing Lorem, right? Okay, we're gonna meet up with Lauren then. Hey yo! You blue bastard! I went to the bar Lorem had suggested as our meeting place. When I looked around, I saw Bryce sitting at a table, talking to someone I couldn't see. I lingered on him for a second, but soon spotted Lorem in the corner of my eye. There you are! Hey Lorem! Oh, it's good to see you. Thought you might not show up. Am I late? Not at all, I got here early. I'm kinda surprised you wanted to meet me here. Don't take this the wrong way, but are you even old enough to drink? What are you talking about? Oh, I see. I can assure you I am a fully grown adult. My species doesn't get much bigger than this. Speaking of which, are you fully grown yet? How big do humans usually get? And how do you stack up, comparatively speaking? Yo, Joshua! Sup, bro? He's so cute. Yeah, he's cute. Oh, and would you mind if I took some notes? Well, before we get to that, you haven't even told me what exactly all this is for yet. Are you sure you're not a reporter? If I was, Sebastian wouldn't have let me meet you in the first place. And I thought the uniform was just a clever disguise. It's real though, Sebastian knows I work for the local post office. Excuse me, but this still doesn't really tell me anything about why I'm here. You're a postman who wants to interview me for what exactly? Sorry, I guess I got ahead of myself here. Maybe a full introduction is in order, and after that you can still decide whether you want to go through with this or not. Hell, I'd hit it. Can't argue with that. Don't forget about the secondary characters. If you're going to continue whining about the secondary characters, I'm going to do those last. Sounds good to me. I recently graduated college with a degree in computing and moved in here with a good friend of mine. This town doesn't exactly offer the best opportunities to put my degree to good use, though. Then why move here in the first place? Living in the city can be very expensive. I can always move later when I get a job there. I've got other plans right now, though. I'm working on a video game. Best character! Hats down, hands down, claws down, feet down, whatever. Best character hands down, no argument. This fucker's working on a video game. He is A-OK in my book. He's mean? Okay, JK. Yeah, of course. Yeah, you would say that, Night Sky, wouldn't you? You fucking bitch. Video game? Well, that sounds interesting. Exactly. Video games and computers are just starting to catch on in places like this town. Making good content will be very important to give a good first impression. And humans have always been part of our media, books, movies, and now games. With you on our side, this could be an amazing opportunity. Pause? Yeah, well, whatever. Well... Oh, maybe this wasn't such a good idea after all. That blush is so cute. Well, why? I don't know. You don't seem so thrilled about doing this anymore. Besides, your job must be really stressful and you're probably already in the spotlight all the time. And now to top it all off, you get some postman harassing you for an interview. If you wanted to leave, I'd get that. Nah, I mean, you make video games, so, you know, I'm actually really interested. I'll stay. Well, I'm already here and have nothing else to do, so let's make the most out of this. Yes, thank you! At least I won't have to be so careful now. With a reporter, I'd have to worry about things being misinterpreted or being taken out of context. You should still be careful. What you tell me now will influence how your entire species will be represented in my game. Don't worry, though. I'll treat this delicate matter with the required finesse. Well, I'm sure of it. How should we do this? Let me think. Why do you want to make this game in the first place? I've always wanted to make a video game. I've had this idea for a while, and it seems now's the right time to do it. It's almost as if you arrived at the perfect moment. Maybe I should start developing like a My Little Pony game then. Maybe, I don't know, ponies will start showing up. I don't fucking know. I don't know. Don't you think my visit will overshadow your efforts? People may not be so interested in playing a game about humans anymore if they had a real one show up. Good point, but the vast majority won't get to meet you personally anyway. If I say I did and modeled the humans in the game after you, people will flock to it to get a similar experience. So I'm gonna be your game's mascot? I guess you could say so. Okay, but why focus on humans? What makes us so important? Well, if there's one thing that people here love, it's humans. Doesn't matter if they just see them in the media or believe in them as mythical creatures. For me, humans were always real. I just didn't know whether I'd ever get a chance to meet one myself. I guess I can cross that one off the bucket list. The facial expressions in this game are a bit lacking. I mean, that's kind of a visual novel thing though. I mean, just what you prefer. You know, it's personal preference. Well, now that we're here, I could tell you that no expense will be spared to make our portrayal of humans as accurate as possible. Oh, you certainly seem passionate. Well, for good reason. I just love humans. Oh, do you? Well, if you say it like that, it actually ends up sounding pretty weird. Besides, what if I turn out to be a horrible person? What would you think about humans then? It wouldn't change anything because I wouldn't base my opinion of an entire species off interactions with a single individual. This guy makes sense! Holy fuck! Well then, what is your current opinion based on us? Well, just the myths we have and the previous portrayal of humans in our media. But I suppose that's why I'm here talking with you right now. I want the truth and all of it. Oh yeah, put that truth in your mouth, boy. Oh, wait. We haven't gotten to that point yet. Well, telling you all of it might not be such a good idea. Oh yeah, I guess that would take a lot more time than we have today. Anyway, what's the actual game about? What do you do? It's a community simulation game. It all starts with the player character moving into a procedurally generated community, which is inhabited by all kinds of mythical creatures, humans included. So it's basically like, you know, any fucking MMORPG ever. Go figure. Mythical creatures like humans. Not only are the towns you move into unique, but the inhabitants are too. There are a variety of traits that get randomized, both in looks and personality. There are many things you can do, but it's very open-ended, and you can live your life there however you want to. That sounds like my kind of game. Oh, really? I couldn't ask for a better compliment than that. Lorem's too pure for that? The Sims? Yeah, basically. Well, what other mythical creatures are there besides humans? Well, I haven't worked that out yet, but humans alone give us a lot of material to work with. How so? Well, the question of the mythical human can be tackled in a variety of ways. There are many different interpretations of what humans are like. For example, in general, the mythical human can be divided into three categories. Firstly, the human as a physical creature. Second, the human as a non-physical entity. And thirdly, the human as a spiritual being. Well, let's start with the physical aspects. Sure. Since one of our myths tells us that the human who created us eventually turned into a dragon, there is a lot of room for interpretation as to how similar humans actually are to dragons. I can see you don't have wings, but most of us are able to create fire in some way, or at least have a breath weapon. How about you? I mean, if you take away my terrible morning breath, not really. Well, I don't have a breath weapon unless you count my this guy just read my mind. I don't think that counts. It's a bit strange though, because our myths also say that you gave that ability to us. Interesting. Maybe it's meant to be taken literally, meaning that when that ability was given to us, you lost it. Or maybe we never had it in the first place. Humans are known to have created a lot of things out of nothing. After all, we only needed to discover how to create and use fire because we didn't have a natural ability to do so. Well, we have a proverb that sums this up pretty well. What is it? Necessity is the mother of invention. Amen. So a lack of natural abilities drove innovation forward. What an interesting thought. Here's another thing. You may have many different images of humans, but in the end, only one can be right. Metalcore already played through the game confirmed? It's also possible that what you've been led to believe about humans doesn't actually refer to us at all. Are you implying that you aren't human? No, I'm just saying that if you really had been in contact with humans before, as your myths imply, they would need to belong to the same species as me, and thus be very similar to myself. If they aren't, then either they weren't humans at all, or have very different origins. So you say there's a possibility that our humans and your humans may be something different altogether? I suppose you are right in the way that our images of humans are very inconsistent. They certainly can't be humans in the way that we would refer to you as a single species. The name should probably be reserved for yours. And we haven't even touched on the two other categories of humans. What did you call them again? Non-physical human entities and spiritual humans. Like the Pope? What's the difference? Honestly, the definitions get a bit muddled here. Going by conventional belief, a ghost could be a human who has died and thus changed into a different form. We would call this a spiritual human. An angel, on the other hand, would be classified as a non-physical entity. I would say the other way around. What do you know about angels? Angels basically look like humans with wings. Their existence in ancient scripts was used to lend some credence to the theories about humans having become dragons. Because of the wings? Exactly. But some of your dragon species don't have wings either. Yes, as I said, once you start delving into that kind of stuff, it all becomes very convoluted. When we met, you also told me something about a four-headed human. Right, with that we'd go into the realm of creatures that just don't make much sense at all. Having four heads just seems unlikely from an evolutionary perspective. That might not really matter if we were talking about a non-physical entity or a spiritual being though. So in the end you have a lot of different ideas whose only connection to each other is that you use the word human to describe them in some way. And they share at least some basic characteristics. You fit those as well, by the way. Well, what are they? You certainly are not a reptile like us, but you don't look like a conventional mammal either. We are mammals, though. Yes, but you are so different from other mammals we know that ultimately you are quite unique. We don't know any other sentient mammals. Oh, you've got a point there. I'll give you that. Strangely enough, we have plenty of human-like creatures in our mythologies as well. Oh, do tell. You already mentioned ghosts, but some others include dwarves, giant fairies, and blemmies. I think I've heard of most of these before, but what is a blemmies? Essentially, a blemmies is a human without a head. A human without a head? How does that work? How do they eat? Instead of a head, they just have all their facial features on their chest. That's a rather weird mental image. Yeah, I agree. There are also a lot of half-creatures that share some characteristics with humans and other animals. Like mere humans? Sure. Lastly, there are creatures that are said to be able to shapeshift into human form. Strangely enough, some of our dragon myths said that they could shapeshift into humans or that certain countries' royalty are descended from dragons. That would imply that they are genetically compatible with humans. I guess. Apparently. Sounds rather outlandish if you ask me. We certainly can't shapeshift like that. Are you sure? To be fair, I never tried. Hang on. Blemmias are just Mr. Potato Heads? Did it work? Nope, still a dragon. Aww. Anyway, how come you know so much about myths? All part of being an ambassador. Not only did I learn about dragon myths in order to compare them to what you're like, but I also studied myths about creatures that are similar to humans so I could find how similar they were to yours. Well, you're doing an excellent job so far, and it's bound to help me a lot with my game as well. You're going to put all of that into the game? Let's just say it gives me some excellent material to work with. I thought you wanted to give an accurate portrayal of humans, not just collect myths. Well, one species will certainly be modeled after you, but that doesn't mean we can't introduce some variety with the others. People will love it if we also bring some of the more unusual myths to life. I see. But since we also want each of the normal human characters to be unique, I'd like to know how much variety there really is within your species. I've seen Reza before, so comparing him to you already gives me a bit of an idea, but how far do these differences go exactly? When we arrived here, you asked me if I was old enough to drink. That leads me to believe that your average human must be a lot taller. Yeah, that's true. You could say Reza would be about average for an adult. Not that it would be impossible to get a good deal bigger than him or even smaller than you. But those cases are rather rare and are usually the result of medical conditions. Delicious chocolate milk. I see. What about colors? Are there any humans who are blue like me? Well, not really. There's a certain spectrum of skin colors that can be lighter or darker, but so far I've seen a lot more variety in the dragons here. We do have quite a number of different eye colors, though. Interesting. As for things that aren't immediately... Did I just spill on myself? The fuck? I spilled Bryce's diarrhea, chocolate milk on my fucking shirt. God damn it! Ew! That's nasty! Well, we certainly have those as well. Some people even believe your blood type influences your personality. That one, on the other hand, is news to me. Anything else you want to know? Phew, we already got so much. I'll have to think about if and how we can work all of this into the game. Have you worked on any other games before? No. Well, I worked on a few small projects during the course of my studies and also interned at a studio before. This is on a completely different level, though. How so? It's my game, so I'm the one calling the shots here. It's a very different thing than just making a few graphics when you're part of a bigger team, for sure. I see. How long exactly have you been working on this? Phew. Must be several months now. I've got everything planned out, and a lot of the groundwork has already been done. The most difficult things are the characters themselves, and to make sure all of the details are accurate. Well, of course. Have you shown the game to other people yet? Sure, feedback is a very important part of the development process, so I regularly gather ideas and opinions from others. I even made a website to do this. 10 out of 10, bro. And what do they say? All kinds of things, really. Sometimes it's hard to decide which ones have a good point and which can be disregarded. Overall, it seems like there are many people who are looking forward to play my game, though. Well, that's good. How many are we talking about? I don't know exactly. The counter on my website only tracks the number of visits, so I don't actually know how many different people there are. Well, what if it doesn't work out? What do you mean? Well, you're investing a certain amount of time and money into making this game. Ideally, you would make back your investment and hopefully get some profit on top of that. Well, if the goal is to make money, sure. However, I just wanted to try my hand at doing something like this. If some people are going to enjoy the end result, that's great. Don't forget that I'll also have made something that I can put on my resume. At the very least, it'll have been a good learning experience. Oh, this guy! Yes! Well, with that attitude, I suppose you really don't have anything to lose. Exactly. I can always look for another job, and maybe I'll end up working at a game studio. But I think once I've started doing something like that, I might not get this opportunity again. So, it's now or never, huh? In a nutshell, yes. And that all works out with the courier job? Sure, I can support myself this way, and I'm not really under any pressure, since I don't have any deadlines to keep. If he made a game like Mass Effect, I would love him forever. I mean, deadlines are a good way to ensure something gets done, though. That I heavily agree with. Oh, you're right about that. It's something where balance is important, I think. I set deadlines for myself, but I don't have to worry about the project breaking down if I don't meet certain milestones at a certain time. The music, though? Yeah, I really like this game's OST. What kind of tools are you using to make it? If I consider what some of your species look like, I'm having a hard time imagining how the bigger ones could program a game. While we do have devices tailored to each individual species, I can't deny that my dexterous hands make it a lot easier compared to some of the others. One downside is that I'll have to keep my nails short, or else using the keyboard gets a bit cumbersome. I imagine you'd have to be careful with those while working as a courier anyway. Oh, you're right about that. One wrong move and you've suddenly shredded the letter you were just going to hand to someone. That sounds unpleasant. Luckily, that kind of thing doesn't really happen to me anymore. Not only because of the shorter nails, but once you've worked there for a while, you just learn to be more careful. It's a bit sad not to have them as a natural letter opener anymore, though. And it's not just for me. Some people ask me to open their letters for them, since doing that on their own can be difficult for some of the less dexterous and older ones. Have you been working as a courier for long? I just got this job a few months ago, but I had a part-time summer job at the post office when I was growing up. My species is perfectly suited for the job, so they were glad to have me on board. Well, I can see why. Of course, being able to fly is a big plus. My size means that I can't deliver any big packages, but I often get assigned to urgent letters that have to be delivered as soon as possible. Huh, it's getting late. Maybe we should leave it at that for today. See No Man's Fail? Yeah, No Man's Sky was... it was too ambitious, and it just... there wasn't really a game there. Yeah, I should probably head back to my apartment before it gets too dark. No Man's Buy. Well, I got more than enough material to work with. Thanks a lot. Don't worry about it. I'll just consider it a public service. Honestly, I'm incredibly grateful for the opportunity, especially after nearly getting denied by Sebastian when I met you. Just make the best of it. I certainly will. I really have to get going now, so maybe I'll see you some other time. Lorm can't handle big packages, winky face. Sure, have a good night. Take care. More free time. Okay, so like I said before, I wasted 70 bucks on that crap. Yeah, that's why I wait for the reviews to come out first, especially these days. No pre-orders for me, bro. So, yeah, as before, I'm going to do it in the way that I said I would. I'm going to do one route at a time.
Sorry.
We're going to relax. Check status immediately. Status, I am good. I am good with Mr. Lorem here. It looks like you've seen this before. Skip the save selection now! Disc makes a good coaster. I'm not even pre-ordering Andromeda. Yeah, no, pre-ordering's not for me, bro. Oh, sure, sign me up. We dislike the stairs. Get crushed again. Well, Raze, of course. Why would he have stayed here? Okay, now we can visit all sorts of places. Okay, let's go to the production facility. Okay, let's visit the library. Who thinks that Metalcore gets the thing he has to do? We have Remy. Oh, hello. So, what did he want here? Hey, it's Remy. I already told you it's not here. Oh god, nope, Metalcore will mess this up. You guys can all go fuck yourselves, okay? Who is he talking to? A dean? Won't you help out an old friend? Friend? This is the first time you've spoken to me in years. And whose fault is that? For you, I didn't even exist these last few years. At least I tried to reach out to you. No, you're just here because you want something. I'm right here, right now, and you still continue to act like that. She was my friend too, you know. I think you should leave. It took me ages to figure out how to get Lorm's good end. Fuck. Well, for what it's worth, I'm sorry. For everything. It's a little late for apologies. Wait, were these two... I mean, these two were together. These two were friends, I mean... I'll have it your way, then. Well, then. Yo, Geth, what's up, bro? Adine stormed out so quickly that she didn't even notice me. I waited a few moments and wondered if it was a good time to talk to Remy. In the end, I decided that my task was too pressing to come back at another time. I shuffled through books and tried to look busy until I noticed that he resumed his work so I could approach him. Hello, Metalcore. How can I help you? Has Reza been here recently? Reza? He's visited quite often since he arrived, actually. Until a few days ago, that is. Do you know what he was reading? Not particularly. I thought he just wanted to learn about our world. She turned him gay? Lol. Did you notice anything unusual about him when he was here? Can't say I did. Though he did ask me for a map once. A map? Yes, I showed him a few, but none of them seemed to be what he was looking for. That face when you get ignored by your waifu? I know, right? Fuck. Did he talk to you about anything strange while he was here? Well, besides the maps, nothing else worth mentioning comes to mind. Only the usual pleasantries. I kinda wanna press on about Adine, to be quite honest. But at the same time, I kinda don't. But I'm gonna do it anyway. Wait, you were here that whole time? Poor Metalcore. Not the whole time, just long enough to know that something's up. It's nothing that concerns you. Come on, it does concern me. I know you, and I know Adine. Well, it's really nothing of great importance. Are you aware of a certain prehistoric underground building we recently discovered? Well, I've heard of it. She wanted a blueprint of it, which is one of the things found inside the building during an investigation. Why would you have it? Well, we're not just a library, you know, but a whole archive that stores all sorts of information and objects. In any case, a blueprint is the kind of thing that would be placed in our care eventually. So she thinks you have it. Well, even if we did, it wouldn't be something we could just give out to anyone. Of course. So how are you doing? I'm doing fine, thank you. Okay, that's it. Okay, that's all. Thanks for your help. You're welcome. Time to report my findings. Air selection now! Oh, what if I don't have any? Then you will listen. Okay, then we do. Oh, can we not help? Well, there's only so much we can do. I was out searching too until I came to meet you. At this rate, it doesn't look like we'll find him today. Okay, thanks, Sebas. The map in the library. I don't know what to think about that. It could have needed a map to plant something, I suppose, but who knows what he really wanted to do with it. It's the kind of detail that on its own might not tell us much, but could be crucial later on. Well done, Metalcore. That gives us some solid points from which we can continue our investigation. Skip! Yo, Lorem! You bitch! Come here! Dude, his apartment looks chill. There you are. Come in. Sure. Honestly, I can't believe he agreed to do this again. He's so cute when he's shy! God! It's my pleasure. Now that I've had a chance to work through everything from last time, we can do some real work. Sounds great. I did a staggering amount of research on mythical humans. Here, let me show you some of the stuff I found. Sure. We sat down at the coffee table. Lauren opened up a laptop and started to type away. Seeing the laptop brought back memories. In our world, they had become obsolete a long time ago. Before I show you these images, I should probably tell you that some of them are really weird. Just don't take them the wrong way. Well, you already told me about the four-headed humans, so I think I can handle this. Alright. No. Just no. That doesn't look very human to me. This one is supposed to be one of our ancestors. Ancestors? Well, it does remind me of some of the dragons I've seen here. But I'm not sure what humans have to do with this. Damn dragon MacBook hipster. Oh, you remember the myth about our creator turning into a dragon, right? It's his human porn collection? Lol. Yeah. Now, here's an interesting question. What species did that human turn into? There are a number of dragon species nowadays that aren't genetically compatible with each other. Did the human choose one of them? Did they perhaps procreate? Wow, what a hottie. Yeah, right. A shared ancestor is one option. This would mean that the different species split after the human's involvement in our creation. If human DNA was involved in some way, this might explain how our different species came to be. Take a far ancestor of ours and apply various amounts of human DNA. The result would be a number of different species, each with a different amount of resemblance to humans. Interesting. Now, it has been said that an upright stance and being able to walk on two legs is a more human trait. Oh. Right. In any case, it's one of the things that make humans unique. As a result, some people believe that certain species share more traits with humans than others. They think it makes them more noble, or something. Luckily, this doesn't happen often. Well, you can walk on two legs as well, right? Sure, in this theory of shared human DNA, this puts me somewhere in the middle, since I still have wings and horns. I can see that. Here, look at this one. What in the ever-loving fuck? That looks more like a troll. I wouldn't want to live in the same town as this fellow. Well, you can't always choose your neighbors, and this won't be any different in my game. I'm not sure he's a particularly friendly one, though. Actually, I think this is supposed to be a human female. Oh, hells no. Wow, hints at your dragon racism? Interesting. There are some that don't think humans are friendly at all, though. Really? So far, I've only heard positive things about us. Some interpretations of our myths don't exactly paint you in the best light. There are also people who oppose the idea of human worship and what their involvement has meant for us. In what way? They say the human interference was unnatural and that we need to go back to our roots. The conservatives. Please, no. Just don't. And how do they think they can do that? Well, apparently it means refusing to use modern technology and living in caves or the wilderness again. Paper bag fixes everything? Like an animal. Pretty much. Most of us think those people are crazy, though. Well, they sound the part for sure. Oh, they're harmless, really. You probably won't see one of them around here anyway. This is an interesting style though. Do you know how these pictures were made? No, I'm sure that information was provided when I looked them up in the library, but I didn't copy all of that. And you're using these as references? I make do with what I can get. Maybe now you can see why I wanted your help though. Alright, what do you need me to do? I just want to make some quick sketches. You can stand over there by the wall. Okay, I can certainly do that. I walked up to the spot that he indicated, and when I took my place, I saw that he had laid out a number of pens, paper, and other art supplies on the table. Oh, this is going to take a while, isn't it? I'll try to be quick about it. You want me to strike a pose or something? A T-pose should be good to get started. What's that? Just point your arm sideways so you look like a giant T. Oh, I get it. Yeah, that's game development 101. The T pose! Raising my arms to the sides, I wonder how long this would take. Yeah, keeping this up for a long period of time is difficult. I can tell you that much. Great, now try to stay still as possible. Here comes that spike. Can I still talk? Sure, as long as you don't talk with your arms. As I wasn't allowed to move my head, I stared at Lorem sketching my figure. This went on for a few minutes until I suddenly heard the sound of a door opening. Oh, look at that! Yeah, that is kinda like Spike. Holy crap! Hey, Lorem. Oh, right, the human was going to visit today. I totally forgot about that. You don't mind if I take a seat, right? You just want to study metalcore. Like you aren't doing that right now. Besides, this room is mine as much as it is yours. I'll just watch and be quiet. I thought you had experiments to run. And they are running. I'd rather not be confined to my tiny room for the next 2 hours, staring at the ceiling and waiting for them to finish. Protagonist claims to be a gamer, doesn't even know T-pose. I don't know, has he ever claimed to be a gamer? I don't think he has. But no experiments on metalcore. Yes, I'll just sit here and maybe take a few notes. I'm sorry, metalcore. This is my roommate and longtime best friend, Ipsum. Nice to meet you, Ipsum. His scientific bluntness may be off-putting, so please bear with him. It's the noodle. Speak for yourself. So much for those two being best friends. Lorem returned to his drawing, the silence only being interrupted by the strokes of his pen. Something interesting happened at work today. Did they finally figure out it was you who was playing all those pranks? No, they'll never catch me. I was talking with a colleague about the humans here, and I offhandedly mentioned that metalcore was going to come over. I don't like where this is going. I don't either. Some hours later, Anna barges into my office and says that metalcore is off limits to anyone besides her as far as tests and experiments are concerned. Well, I'm not taking any samples, so I could hardly be blamed for just looking at metalcore. Yes, but that makes me wonder. Metalcore, did you agree to visit her and undergo her rigorous testing regimen? Oh, I did. Oh, good luck to you then. Oh, and Lorem, have you seen my Ixamen sphere recently? Didn't you take it with you when we went to the park the other day? Yes, I did. Well, that's the last time I saw it. I must have lost it then. I already searched the whole apartment. Did you go into my room? ... No. Maybe someone found it. I had it registered in my name when I found it, so if anyone found it, it should show up sooner or later. What is an Ixamen sphere anyway? It's just a glorified toy for grown-ups, really. You have no idea what you're talking about. An Ixamen sphere is a very sophisticated tool with a countless number of uses. Like what? It can levitate and follow you around, take photos. You can even use it as a calculator. I want 3 of them, right now. Making it into a glorified toy for grown-ups. I use it for my experiments. Well, if they could take photos, I wouldn't need to stand around like this. That is, if we had it here now. It's a great companion for all situations in life. Well, it's much easier to draw from a life model than from a photo, though. Easier for you, maybe. I hope this doesn't take much longer, because my arms went numb a while ago. Yeah, I think you can relax for now. I'm nearly done with this one. A tingling sensation went up my arms as I relaxed. Slowly, I began to regain feeling in them. Alright, now turn around. I thought we were done already. Not unless we want our humans to lack a backside. The iRock. I use it for recording porn? Yeah, I bet you do, Night Sky. I bet you do. You disgusting fuck. So that's what this is all about. You know what I mean. Ha! I know exactly what you mean. Isn't it my turn to draw you now? That's not how it works. I wouldn't mind getting a portrait of myself. I can already see it. The light shining from above, caressing my luscious mane, highlighting every lock as they interplay. This is going to be a long day. That depends on how fast you were. As I was now facing the wall, I couldn't see what Lorem and Ipsum were doing. After a few seconds of silence, I heard some whispering coming from the couch. What are you talking about? I didn't want to be rude, but I was just curious about your vestments. He said, and I quote, "This would be more interesting if it wasn't for those clothes Metalcore was wearing." I see how it- oh, really? I'm just saying it would be hard to study an insect if there was a piece of cloth draped over it. Wearing that much just seems odd to me. If humans wear clothes like this, it's only appropriate to depict them as such. And my scientific curiosity shall remain unsatisfied. Well, because Metalcore is not here to do that, and you would get into big trouble with Anna. Well, it did suggest a card for Cards Against Humanity that was trying to gather several Ixtamen spheres to use as anal beads? I don't know how big those things are, so... Well, we actually have a pretty big variety of vestments. I could tell you about it. Sounds good, but not right now. I have to finish this up first. Alright. So, Ipsum, I've heard a lot about experiments in science by now, but what do you actually do? I work in the facility as a biologist with a minor in physics. In addition to the office, I also have my own setup here at home. I assure you it's properly isolated from the rest of your apartment. From our apartment, duh. It even has a fume hood to prevent accidents. But I only use it for the smallest of experiments. Usually things unrelated to my job. Oh, like smoking weed? You fucking hippie. Sounds interesting. Don't get him started or we won't hear the end of it. Well, maybe you would like to talk... Maybe you would like to talk about your hobby instead, Lorem. Isn't this already a hobby? I guess you could say so. I was talking about his other hobby, though. Oh, that. That doesn't spell out much good. I don't know. It's a little embarrassing, to be honest. Wait a minute. Is this motherfucker a crossdresser? Is he? I wonder. I seriously wonder. Well, there's no need to be embarrassed about your hobbies. He likes flowers. Once he even made a crown out of daisies. Cutest thing in the world. Close enough, I guess. I mean, nothing wrong with that. Don't listen to him. As usual, he only tells half the story. Well, what's the other half then? Well, I have an extensive love for botany. Well, there you go. The fern he keeps in his room must be the happiest plant alive. I find gardening to be very relaxing, especially when the birds are singing in the morning. It's so nice to go out there with a nice cup of tea and work in the garden of our apartment building. Which reminds me, Ipsum here has quite an extensive tea collection. Although I'm not sure if he prefers to hoard tea or gadgets. It's a mystery. Maybe he likes to, hoard tea gadgets? Ever thought of that? I heard there was going to be a model of the Ixamon Sphere that can actually make tea. That's going to be a must-buy. Waifu can even grow my weeds. Can it also make cups, or are you supposed to sip it out of the sphere itself? Don't be silly. You two sound just like an old couple. Couple? Us? Not really. We've known each other for a long time, though, if that counts. I think it does. By the way, Ipsum, you're not from here, right? What is that supposed to mean? Well, you look nothing like any other dragon I've seen here so far. I suppose that's true for Lorem as well. You're both pretty small. But you, Ipsum, also have hair. That's certainly new. It's not as unusual as you might think, but you're right. There aren't many of us in these parts. I imagine being smaller than the rest of the population would come out with would come with its own challenges. It's not that big of a deal. If something is unreachable for me, I can fly. This apartment was actually intended to house one dragon of a bigger size. That only makes it fairly cheap, but it's also big enough for both of us. There's one thing I've been wondering. How do you even sit in one of those chairs? Wouldn't the backrest cause problem with your tails? I see what you mean. For me, it's never been a problem, because most chairs are bigger than I am. Well, it's just a question of getting in the right position. A rare noodle. However, this might be different from those of us who mostly walk on four legs, but they don't use chairs like these at all. I've seen a few try, though. I suppose they want to imitate humans this way. Even if they can't stand or walk like a human, they can try to sit like one. Yeah, I know another person, or pony, who tries that. Oh, with varying results. Some I've seen look really funny, trying to fit in chairs they are too big for, or sitting in odd ways that clearly don't work with their anatomy. Like I said, I know a certain someone who does that as well. I see. Lorem, you asked me about breath weapons last time, but I don't think you ever told me if you had one. Probably because it isn't worth mentioning. You cock! It may only be a very small flame, but it can get very hot. What about you, Ipsum? Yes, Ipsum, what about you? My breath weapon is electrocution. Since words... Was it elocution? Oh. Since words are more powerful than anything else. Well, I mean, if you're dragonborn, you know, Fusroda, Yortushul, etc., etc. Same as mine, then. Alright, I'm done with this one. You can turn around. Does this mean we're done? Sure. Let's make one more. Maybe something dynamic. Well, how dynamic are we talking about? Something that isn't static, like the reference models I just did. Or you can strike a pose. Something that's just... you. Alright. What kind of pose should I go for? Swimwear pose? Guess I'd go for a thoughtful pose. Alright, what about this? Works for me. By the way, did you get the groceries when you came home from work? Yes, just as usual. Powerful words, shoop da whoop. Oh god. I'm a fire in my laser, bang! Are you too sure you're not in a relationship? I certainly am. Actually, Ipsum is deeply in love with his home laboratory. Oh really? I'm not even going to deny that. When I'm not working on something at the office, I do so here. What are you currently working on? I've been looking into the physics of teleportation. You're talking about the portal, right? Well, I don't have permission to even approach the portal, so I have to resort to a theoretical discussion on its mechanics, and have to make do with what I can pull off in my home laboratory. Yeah, creating black holes and the such probably isn't gonna happen in there. Oh, maybe I could tell you a few things. That won't be necessary. I have already read all the available test reports. Okay. Are you aware that using the portal could be incredibly dangerous? I'm not sure what you're talking about. Well, then you don't actually have a complete understanding of what the portal actually does and what it means for our world at large. In order for a portal to function, a natural wormhole is required. It is trapped and becomes the portal's entry. The portal manipulates the wormhole's exit. This way, something can be sent to whichever destination is chosen. Now, there is a theory about the purpose of the natural wormholes in the universe. It states that they act as the support pillars of the space-time continuum. How so? How should I explain this? Oh, we are getting into theoretical astrophysics and shit. Oh, this is lovely. I think the video game analogy worked pretty well. Sure. In a video game, what happens when you meet the edge of a map? Or you hit a wall? That happens in some games, but in others, you reappear on the opposite side. Right. How does this happen? If our world was a perfect sphere, someone could just keep on flying in the same direction, and eventually they would end up at their starting point again. By the way, BRB, science is not my thing and I have to do something. You wuss. You're not an egghead. Get out. Sure. This is just a result of physics. In the abstraction of a video game, however, it doesn't work like that. They don't try to replicate a spherical world, but use a 2D plane instead. This is getting confusing. Is this getting confusing? Motherfucker, you are a biologist and a sociologist. Come on, you should be able to get, at the very least, this. Well, imagine a piece of paper with a world map printed on it. Right. While it shows the entirety of the world, it is still just a simple flat piece of paper rather than a sphere, right? Sure. Let us assume that in a game, our world map looks like that. Now, what happens when we approach the edge and walk over it, that we are teleported to the other side? Okay. This doesn't actually make the game world a sphere, but rather a torus. A torus? You know, like a donut. If that's the comparison you want to make. Okay. Now, things are going to get really complicated. Are you familiar with the mini-worlds interpretation of quantum mechanics? Yes, I am, in fact. Let's say I'm not. It states that every single time a choice is made by any actor that possesses free will, the universe splits off into different branches. This means that for every choice you have made, there exists a branch of the universe where you made a different decision. I see. Now, we can't communicate with these other branches in any way. You don't know what would happen if you had made a different decision this morning. You could make an educated guess, but the only person who truly knows what would happen is that alternate you who has made that decision and is living its consequences. That is, unless we could communicate with those other branches. However, there is a barrier that prevents us from doing that. This barrier is made up of wormholes. How does that work? It's very similar to the torus world model that is used in games. As we approach the edge of our world, of our own world, the barrier causes us to end up on the other side instead. Does this mean we get teleported to the other side like in video games? Not necessarily. It would just be as correct to assume that our universe is shaped like a torus. So which is it then? Do we get teleported or not? That depends on how you look at the wormhole's function. Imagine this sheet of paper is the entirety of our world. He took a sheet of paper from Lorm's stack and showed it to me, marking a spot near the edge with a pen. And this is where you live. Unfortunately, your workplace is here on the other side. This is from Interstellar. I remember this analogy. He drew an X close to the right edge of the paper. If the world was flat, this would be very unfortunate. However, if the world was a torus, the left and right edges would be connected. You could take a shorter route by going over the edge. Now let's say this is only possible because wormholes connect these two together. If you happen to be right at the very edge and look beyond, everything would look fine for you. Given that these wormholes stay in their place, you would never know that the world is actually flat and that you can only travel to the other side because the wormholes connect the edges. You would think that the world is a torus. Right. However, what if the wormholes don't actually bring you to the other side by teleporting you, but instead just bend the paper into the torus shape and hold the edges together? If these wormholes failed or were displaced, the paper would unfold, throwing the world into disarray. That's what the wormholes and the barrier actually do. They are what hold everything together. So they're really more like glue. If it wasn't for them, the overall construct would collapse in on itself. What construct? The entirety of space-time. Of course, you dummy. Have you even been listening these last few minutes? You idiot. Good God, this is the kind of science that I love with a passion. Now, if these theories are true, that would mean using a portal damages the barrier. Each time the portal is activated, the wormhole used for the teleportation is displaced, leaving a small gap where it used to be. Do this too often, and the overall system will destabilize eventually. Alright, maybe you shouldn't talk about your theories about how the world is going to end. Nothing is going to happen because the portal was used a few times. I just hope humanity is aware of its implications. Well, maybe we can collaborate. I certainly hope so. Your researchers seem to know what they're doing. I just wish I could be a part of it. With everything that's going on, the future looks incredibly exciting. What do you think is going to happen, Ipsum? Now you'll get him started. Don't say I didn't warn you. Well, the knowledge contained within your PDAs could propel innovation forward by unseen lengths, meaning a lot more experiments for you to do, which would be terribly exciting. Personally, I'm more interested in the social implications. What do you mean? I don't expect there to just be a back and forth of ambassadors forever. Are you talking about colonies? Oh, I bet Lauren would jump at the opportunity to live in the human world. I'm not sure if that would be a good idea. Why not? Obviously, such an endeavor would need a lot of preparation. We would need to learn about their culture and adjust appropriately. I'd expect we'd send an ambassador over there long before that will happen, though. We hardly know anything about their world. Yeah, thing is, the place is kind of a shithole at the moment, okay? Just don't mind the mess. Well, everything's still up in the air as far as diplomatic relations go. We have no idea what the situation could be like in just a week. Yes, and it's also incredibly exciting. Don't get too excited though, or else you're gonna ruin your drawing. It's almost done anyway. Here, what do you think? Lorem leaned over, holding up the paper to Ipsum. Ipsum looked at the paper closely, his gaze shifting back and forth between me and the paper several times. After a few seconds, he seemed to be finished with his evaluation. As a scientist, my professional opinion is that this part looks a little long. Lorem, just let me tidy up my planet real quick. He pointed his sharp claw at a part of the paper Lorem was holding. Are you sure? Let me see. If I wasn't sure, I wouldn't have said it. I think you're right. That I am. Lorem reached for his eraser, purging a few lines from the paper before he switched to his pen again. Fuck that, get a new one fixed. And it's done. See, what would you ever do without me? I don't think I'd hear as many explosions in the middle of the night. Well, you were happy about it when you forgot to set your alarm that one time. Suddenly, the sound of an alarm resounded throughout the room. Ooh, my experiment is done. And there he goes. Charming fellow, isn't he? Yeah. He certainly keeps things interesting around here. And he's a good art critic. I can imagine. Anyway, looks like we're done here. Whew. Feels good being able to move again. Would you like to stay for dinner? It'd be the least I can do to compensate for your lost afternoon. Let me see, what time is it? It is, let me stick my dick up your butthole before 10. It's getting late, and I probably shouldn't stay out this long. Looks like I'll have to decline for now. I see, well, I gotta do something for you at least. Well, how about you, how about you just, give me a quickie? Don't worry about it. Maybe some other time. If you say so. Thanks for doing this. At any rate, it's been a huge help. Yeah, I know. Don't worry about it. Really. Alright. I should really get going now. Sure. Take care. Interesting fellow. Same thing with his roommate. Nothing going on today. Guess I can do whatever. I saw this joke coming miles away. I am going to be an egghead. Ba-bam! Intuition, Chapter 3. I see fire. I don't like that. Who am I going to meet with today? Or no, I'm gonna have to... Skip to the scene selection. Now! You know what? Let's check our status with the guy. We are still only good status. Hmm. And these are the things I am in possession of. Well, it's my best bet finding the truth. Oop! There's a Dean. Know her? A little. Now we can't go through. There we go here. Okay. So now we're back here again. Let me see, what have I not done yet? Let me see, I've gone to the store, I've gone to the production facility, and I've visited the police archives, so... I've basically done everything in this list, right? Fuck it, production facility. Fuck it! Oh! Lorem, hi! I didn't know this fucker was gonna be here. Did I just get his... What? What are you doing here? Lorem, what are you doing here? I'm just fetching some equipment for Ipsum. He's in the middle of an experiment and really needs this stuff. He sounded very emotional, which is very unusual for him. Sounds like it's serious. And you're here for important human business, I bet. Sure. By the way, do you still accept my invitation? I have something really neat planned. Sounds great, but I'm pretty busy right now. It's no problem, really. Just let me know when you have the time and I'll make it happen. I should really get going before Ipsum blows up the apartment. Sure, take care. You too. This should be the right place. Knock, knock. Okay, so now we're asking about... Wait, I don't think I've done this one before. He doesn't like me asking about this. And who are you to go around asking questions like that? I'm working with the police on this matter. And I'm supposed to believe that? For all I know, you could be with the murderer and are just here to find out if I know something that could implicate you. Well, according to my information, you didn't particularly like the victim. Not only were you the last person to see her alive, but you were also the ones who found her. As you may imagine, this warrants some questions. You know what? I don't have to listen to this. I don't know who you think you are, barging into my workplace and barking questions. But if you really are with the police, let them know that I won't say one more word on the matter without a lawyer. Cock. Well, I wondered if Damien was a suspicious person in general, or if the rumors surrounding Reza were affecting his perception of me. Before this, everyone I had talked to during my investigations had been rather cooperative. Cock! Cock! Don't go to the portal. Well, I'm going to stay inside and call the police because, well, I really have no... What a bitch! Yeah, it was kind of being an asshole, dude. Or dick. He's a bitch dick! Dick bitch! He's a ditch! I assume we are going to let Metalcore make all the decisions himself? Well, of course. Of course you are going to make me do all the decisions! I'm just thinking back on the previous route where I did go to the portal. Was there anything weird that happened then? I mean, I only ran over there and got, you know, knocked out by the administrator. That's gonna be hard. E-bitch. Yeah. Sure, let's go with that. I have a feeling that Lore might come out because he's a curious fucker. I don't know, though. I should do coin flip. Let me see, I think you can get Google to do that, right? Coin flip. Okay, heads, we stay inside. Coin, we go to the portal. There it is. Go to flip it. They got tails, we're going. Okay, that didn't appear to have mattered all that much. Welp. Okay, Lorem, come over here, you big bitch. Ding dong. Hello? Hey, Lorem. Hey, Metalcore. So, where exactly are we going? You mentioned something about treasure hunting, but don't tell me we're actually trying to unearth some ancient human artifacts. No worry, this is going to be fun. Yeah, right. I'll just hope for the best. I'm not sure who came up with it, but someone gave this kit to me as a present a few months ago. He showed me the map. It was a piece of paper that had obviously been treated to look much older than it really was. Well, sounds like fun. I'm glad you agree. I'm not sure if I can be much of assistance, though. I don't exactly know much about the area. But you're big and strong. I beg to differ. Or at least you are bigger and stronger than I am. That may be very true. You can do the digging. You're the one with claws here, you cocksucker! These things are not meant to dig. Great. So I'm just your slave. Well, besides, I wanted to do this for a while now, and Ipsum is always busy, so I figured this would be as good a time as any. Do we need to bring a shovel, or do you expect me to dig with my bare hands? Well, the instructions, we only need this map and a pen. What about ourselves? I think that one's a given. Great, then we're all set. So, where are we supposed to go? If this is the facility, then the place indicated is the school. Or rather, somewhere between the school and the administrative building. Let's go then. Allons-y! To adventure! I'm gonna get raped in some back alley. Here we are. The X on the map is right between these two buildings, so it must be around here somewhere. Back to school, huh? Not quite yet. Everyone's on summer break right now. Which is a good thing, because we really wouldn't want you to get swarmed by all the children. They would go crazy if they saw you. How does school work here anyway? Are you talking about this one, or schools in general? In general. I'd like to know more about how your school system works as a whole. I see you won't let a learning opportunity go by. I'm just doing my job. You should start looking for that treasure then. Sure. While I looked for hints as to the treasure's whereabouts, Lorem started talking. Right, we do have quite the education system. Different schools and different districts run on their own, so when looking at details, things can vary quite a lot. However, there are a few things that are true no matter what region you are in. Compulsory education lasts for about 10 years. There are a lot of options for schools and school systems. Choice is an important factor here. We recognize that there isn't one system that works best for everyone, so there are many options depending on what path you want to take. Thank you! You have that figured out! Cock. Well, that doesn't sound too different from what it used to be like in my world. Aim before the real treasure is the friends you make along the way. But nowadays, things are a bit more chaotic. Practical skills are valued most in our city, and you aren't really given a choice to do anything else. Sure, people can learn other things on their own, but it's not as if school is mandatory anymore. People just do whatever they feel like. Did you grow up like that too? No, I still got to experience our old education system, college included. What was your favorite subject? This guy doesn't seem like much of an egghead. He does seem like a bit of an artist because he was also talking about making graphics. So I'm gonna say art. Really? Me too. I always like trying out different mediums. I tried sculpting again recently. What for? Art doesn't need a justification. But anyway, it helps me visualize what the characters in my game should look like. That's pretty clever. Can't you do that with a computer? Sure, but working with a physical medium makes things easier for me. Instead of working with an interface, there's only my hands and a lump of clay. No technological gadgets required. I see. Did you find anything yet? I sure haven't. No, I feel like we must be missing something. Maybe, but the map clearly marked this place. You can see it for yourself. Yeah, the X definitely points to this alley. Then it must be here somewhere. Look in the trough. Maybe that's something to do with the water trough and the faucets? Maybe. Let's check it out. We walked over and looked inside the water trough. Inside, the dirt was already a few inches high, a clear indicator that it hadn't been cleaned for a while. I guess the janitor is on summer break too. Or maybe they left it here on purpose because our treasure is inside. It's all dried up though, way too hard to start digging. Maybe that's what the faucets are for. If you say so. You are going to clog up the system, you idiot! We turned on the faucets and watched as the trough slowly filled with water. That should be enough. And now? We start digging. Come on, what kind of treasure hunters would we be if we didn't get our hands dirty? I immersed my hands in the sludge. This is still pretty hard. Let's turn on the water again then. Lorem joined me. Both of us dug around in the sludge, which slowly became clearer as more water filled the trough.
Hey, I think I got something.
Really?
Yeah, I think it's stuck to the bottom. Lorem's face was straining as he tried to pull harder and harder on the object he had found. That's probably, you know, the thing that keeps the thing sealed. Maybe I should try? No, we call it a stop. But it's... I think I got it! Suddenly, his hands reappeared from beneath the murky water, holding a small shiny object in their grasp. There it is! What is it? He opened his hands to reveal a big screw. Oh. Maybe you should put that back. Yeah, maybe. By now, the water had become clear enough that we could see where the screw originally was. After Lauren replaced it, we noticed that besides the water, the trough was completely empty. I guess it's not here after all. But at least the janitor will be grateful for the cleaning. Maybe. Let's examine the walls. Maybe it has something to do with the walls. What makes you think so? Well, we're clearly missing something here, so maybe there's some sort of hint we've been overlooking. Something that wouldn't be obvious to anyone else who came through here. I have no idea what you're talking about. These walls don't really look special to me. My gaze slowly went along the walls, trying to find something, anything that could be that could have a hidden meaning. Hey, look at that. What do you mean? That kind of looks like an X on the wall, don't you think? I guess so. Maybe it's here somewhere. Look, there! Lorem crouched down and stuck his hand in an indentation that ran along the wall near the ground. Aha! What is it? He pulled out a cylindrical, shiny object and held it up to me. It looks like some sort of capsule. Maybe there's something inside. In before anthrax, or like, you know, mustard gas? Rip. Maybe it's a pipe bomb! That would be a fucking twist, wouldn't it? Like, he pulls it open and suddenly both his hands get blown off? That's going to be a pretty small treasure. He screwed it open and held the two halves of the cylindrical object in his hands. To our surprise, it didn't have an empty space on the inside. Nothing could be hidden within. Instead, the inside of the two halves were engraved. What does it say? 2J. That's it? Yep, it's also on the other half. It might be coordinates. The grid on the map had numbers and letters like that. That means 2J would be here. Right in the middle of a forest. Let's go! Oh boy, we're going into the forest. Yeah, we're gonna get raped by fucking little critters. It's gonna be South Park all over again. Ugh. Finding our spot might be a little bit more difficult from here on out. Why is that? We don't really have buildings and addresses as references anymore. Here we only have a spot in the middle of the forest. Don't worry, I have an excellent sense of navigation. Well, I mean, he is the delivery guy, so makes sense. Let's hope we find it before it gets too dark though, or things might become a lot more complicated. I'd rather not get lost here. You won't have to worry about anything. If there are any predators in the area, they'll see me as a better target than you. Yeah, that might be the reason they'll kick me in the face as well. Don't tell me there are predators in these woods. Not really, there might be a stray or two, but that should be it. These woods are considered to be very safe. Even if that's true and if worse comes to worse, you can just fly away. I guess that's true. You kind of sound like you don't like the woods though. Well, I like it, as long as it's safe. Then you don't have anything to worry about here. If you say so. I already told you there shouldn't be any really be any predators in these parts. And it's not like these woods are haunted or anything. Oh, now you've just gone and fucking ruined it. Thanks. Haunted? That reminds me of something. What is it? Maybe you're interested in this. In our world, there's a forest that was notorious for the many suicides that took place there. It was said to be haunted by angry spirits. Oh yeah. Of course, Suicide Forest. I know about that. I know that forest very well, actually. Just Pericles lurk within the darkness? That sounds horrible. But why are there so many suicides there? And why are the spirits so angry? Well, in Japanese folklore, people have a soul or spirit that is called Reikon. Upon a person's death, the Reikon separates from the body and goes through a form of purgatory. After certain rites have been performed, the Reikon then goes on to join its ancestors and become a protector of the living family. However, under certain circumstances, like the rites not being performed correctly or dying in a sudden or violent manner, the Reikon transforms into a Yurei instead. The Yurei can return to the physical world and haunts it until it has been laid to rest. So there you go, another myth for your collection. Well, I know where not to go for my next vacation now. Yeah, you wouldn't want to go to on a vacation to Suicide Forest. Besides, like, a lot of that forest is actually, you know, it is sealed off. You're not allowed to go there because of all the fucking bodies everywhere. Oh, I wouldn't want to visit either. That makes two of us. What do you think about stuff like that? Paranormal stuff? You know, until a few weeks ago, humans were still just a myth. And if we look at the portal, it's like, well, something that came out of science fiction. Ipsum certainly seemed interested in it. He is. He actually read up on some new theories about it. Like what? You remember him telling about the different branches and how the barrier separates them, right? Yeah. So, since the barrier is made up of wormholes and using the portal displaces them, it leaves gaps in the barrier. I distinctly remember him talking about something like that because that would also eventually bring about the end of the universe. Through these gaps, he thinks we can communicate with our alternate selves in the other timelines. Wow, that would be unsettling. How does that work? It all goes into the nature of existence itself. Oh god, please. I know it's fun, but I've been reading for a long fucking time. Who are you as a person? Do you think you are just the metal core from this branch? What about the ones from all the other timelines who have made other decisions? That is basically this game's mechanic. Would you consider yourself to be the same person as them? The only difference between you and the metal core from another branch may be that you decided to skip breakfast this morning. Maybe you are all of them. How is that possible? Like a seed from which many roots can sprout, or a tree in its branches, there may be a uniting factor that branched off into these different timelines, your fundamental nature. You might call it a soul or something similar, but the idea is that even though there are many different versions of you, there is an aspect that unites all of you. In this case, probably that I want to save this fucking universe. A part of myself that stands over me, kinda like a superego. An interesting comparison. If we use a similar model here, then we can say that you are also made up of three distinct parts. In each timeline, you have a physical body which is driven by its own base desires that it seeks to fulfill. All physical needs like hunger, thirst, and even breathing fall under this category. However, as a being with free will, you are also capable of making your own decisions. That includes being able to act contrary to what your body is telling you. Yeah, Lauren's path is interesting, but long. This ability to think and make decisions on your own is your rational mind, the self. And lastly, there's the third part I just talked about. The one that stands all above all of you and unites you in some way. Let's call this your higher self. Through this higher self, you may be able to communicate with your alternate selves in some way. Usually the barrier would prevent this, but through the gaps, communication becomes a possibility. The more gaps there are, the easier this should be. And how would I go about doing that? I suppose that would be the job of the higher self. So I can't control it? These are all just theories. We wouldn't really know until it happened. Only then we could... Only then we could study it. Well, if it was to happen, how would I know? If someone else's experience get relayed through this connection to you, it could manifest in a number of ways. Like, deja vu. Maybe it could be something like a deja vu or a false memory. Maybe even dreams. But the biggest difficulty would be to recognize that this phenomenon is happening in the first place. It's certainly quite out there, you have to admit. Sure, but quantum mechanics are already complicated enough. Once you look at what lies beyond, it's just crazy territory. Yeah, quantum mechanics on their own are already pretty fucking difficult to comprehend. Now you're going even beyond that. Just like... What do you think about all this? I think it might already be happening. Really? Just think about it. If the possibility of it ever happening is there, then it is more than likely that it already has. I'm not sure if I follow. Let us assume that this is an average timeline. The portals have been found by both of our people, contact has been made, and now you and Razor are both here for a visit. A few letters were exchanged before you and Razor were sent here, so that means the portal has already been used a few times. Using a portal once might only have an infinitely small effect on the barrier, like poking a hole in a castle wall with a needle. However, if you multiply this by a nearly... Keegan got his buns? He's done some generous soul actually donated $100? Are you fucking kidding me? Nice! Hey, man, round of applause to that guy, whoever the fuck that is. Round of fucking applause. Goddamn. That's good, dude. Fuck. Like I said, round of applause for that guy. Let me see if I can check on Discord real quick. I'm gonna do so through the power of my cell phone, of course. Holy fuck, man, $100? I wish I had that kind of money to toss around. The dude's lit as fuck, props to him. So 80 for the shipping. Okay. Alright. He's at 110%. America, build a wall and pay taxes for it. Okay, Oh, now Keegan's crying again. Aww. Hey, man, well, congrats on that, bro. Yeah, it's like 400%? Are you joking? What? Congrats from everyone watching the stream right now. At Oki. I don't think I've ever seen this guy. Let me see, who is this? I don't think I've ever seen that guy, to be quite honest. Looks like the schlongs come with all the bells and whistles. Fucking A, dude. This is exactly why I love this community, you know, we just... You know, he posted that as a joke. And now he's actually got it. Fucking amazing, dude. Okay, so let's just continue going. However, if you multiply this by a nearly infinite number of possible timelines in which these same events are happening, the effects must already be noticeable. Of course, some people may be more susceptible to this than others. Do you think you've already experienced it? I don't know. I've been having some weird dreams lately. I mean, I have too. Well, me too. Really? We were just entering a clearing, and from my view, I could see some odd lines that had been drawn on the ground. What is this all of a sudden? This is like 3D rendered and shit. What the hell? Hey, I think this is the spot. Why do you think so? Well, the giant X on the ground kind of gives it away. Lorem took flight with a few flaps of his wings. After looking at the scenery from above, he returned to me. You're right, it does look like a giant X. Guess it's time to get our hands dirty again. That may not be necessary this time. What are you talking about? He went to the center where the lines crossed and picked up an object that was lodged halfway into the ground. He returned to me once more, holding another capsule similar to the one we had found near the school. If we have to go back to town after walking all this way, I'll... And it's open. Apparently we're going to 6K now. What has happened? Well, we're doing Lorem's route and, well, there's a lot of other stuff that's happened. People in the chat will be able to catch you up on it. Because, I mean, I'm still busy with this. Yeah, there's a lot of gotcha going on in the Discord server. And where's that? There's an abandoned store on the other side of the forest. That's where we're going. That just means the way back is going to be even longer. Okay, I'll wait for it to be a video. I mean, you can skip back if... I mean, you could rewind if I'm correct. I should have that option enabled so you can just scroll all the way back. Are you sure we should even be here? Well, this is the place indicated by the map. I was talking about the building being roped off. Maybe that's just part of the game. Is the flooding part of the game too? Hey, you can give up if you want to. I certainly won't. Now, are you going to help me or not? I guess. I mean, I've already come all this fucking way. I just didn't expect that I'd have to get wet for this. All part of being a treasure hunter. Let's just look for the X. Have fun and have a great night. Like I said, you could just skip back. Sure. Lorem flew up to the light fixtures to get a view from above while I checked out the shelves. I remember when we could still shop here. What happened? Apparently the area has a problem with flooding. And you don't fucking say. I can see that. So much work and resources are needed to erect a building like this one, and in the end it just gets abandoned. Well, we have plenty of empty buildings where I come from. Oh really? Not sure if this is a good reminder of home though. Well, at least we don't have a problem with flooding. Yeah, but we have other shit to deal with. Laura makes metalcore wet. I nearly got sent back, by the way. Really? Why? Political reasons. Oh, I don't think I'm supposed to talk about it. Well, you just did. Is it related to that announcement they made about Reza? Maybe. Huh, I guess things are pretty serious. They are. Have you found anything yet? Not really. Maybe it's underwater. You think so? It's certainly not anywhere near the ceiling. I already checked there. And I found nothing near the walls or the shelves. It could be hidden beneath a floor tile or something like that. I suppose you're right. Let's do it. All right. Without hesitation, Lorem vanished beneath the water's surface. I breathed in deeply, crouched down, and began looking underwater as well. I mean, you could just, you know, fucking look down? Should... Wait, how deep is this? Excuse me? What the fuck? Okay, there's a hell of a lot of water there, what the shit? I looked around, but nothing seemed out of the ordinary for me. Just as I was about to resurface and get some air, I heard a splash accompanied by a thud, loud thud. What the fuck? What was that? Lorem? Everything was quiet as I looked around for my companion. Suddenly, I heard frantic knocks coming from a shelf that was lying on the ground, half submerged in the water. I realized that it was still standing when we came earlier. As I waded over to it, it soon became clear that the knocks were coming from beneath. Oh, he's gonna drown! Shit! Lorem? Quickly, I mustered all my strength and grabbed the shelf, lifting it up until it fell over to the other side with a loud splash. Lorem resurfaced, gasping for breath. What just happened? I was looking underwater and suddenly the shelf just came down on me. Are you okay? Yeah, I think so. My leg hurts a bit, but that's about it. But I totally saw something. Let me show you. I mean, the fucker almost just drowned and he's like, well, whatever, let's just do this. Without waiting for a reply, Lorem dove down into the water again, resurfacing just a few seconds later, holding an ominous metal box that had a large X on it. This should be it. Let's hope it's waterproof, though. From the looks of it, it is. We should go outside, though. It'll be hard to read anything in here. Sure. What if I wasn't strong enough to lift up that shelf? That would fucking suck. We would have a dead Lorem on our hands now. Well, what's inside? Lorem held up the box to me. I took one of the sheets of paper that were inside and started reading. I think these are pizza vouchers. Lorem was holding another sheet, which he started reading aloud. Congratulations, you have solved Pantoli Pizza's annual treasure hunt. Remember the code word enclosed for an instant rebate on your next order and a chance for the grand prize. You could be a lucky winner for a year's supply of Pantoli's Pizza. This competition will run until before now. Oh, what is it? It's expired. The treasure hunt, the contest, apparently it all ended months ago. Can we still get the pizza? Well, I don't think that offer is still valid. I mean, we could still get pizza regardless. This whole thing has made me really hungry. God damn it, now you're making me hungry, you asshole! I suppose this concludes our treasure hunt. Well, what do we do now? Maybe we could see this experience as another reminder that the journey is its own reward. Ugh. Or that the early bird gets the worm. You really want some pizza, don't you? That makes me wonder though, why didn't they get rid of the hints in this box when the contest expired? Well, they must have realized that people may still have these kits at home even if the contest was over. If people went out looking for a hint in the woods and it wasn't there anymore, they might look for hours until they decided there was nothing left to find. Or they just didn't care. You know, I'm slowly starting to lose hope in Pantoli's Pizza. Sending us here really is negligent. Who knows what would happen to you if I wasn't there? Maybe this whole building could crash down on the next unlucky people who end up here. Maybe that's why it was roped off in the first place. But you thought it was part of the game. Maybe they should have put up a sign or something. While I was talking, Lorem walked to one of the wooden poles that was used to rope off the building. He picked up a large rectangular object from the ground that was hidden in the grass. It was a wooden sign. Warning, do not proceed past this point. The treasure hunt has concluded and there is nothing more to find. Danger ahead. Oh, we could find the huge treasure, but not this huge sign? What does that say about us? I'm not sure exactly. We should probably head back before it gets too dark, though. We still have to go through the woods again. Alright, let's go. You want to pick up some pizza on the way home? Oh, hells yeah. I don't know. That's the wrong answer, bro. When someone asks, do you want to get pizza? You say, yes, sir, I do. And we're going to rest again. Chapter 4, Passion and Superstition. Bang bang! Good morning! So you're gonna skip happy bed? No! BRB once again. Okay. My question. Am I going to go into this place with Bryce? Or am I going to have to let him die? This is one of the only things I'll ask. Unless that it will spoil the whole route. Speaking of which, status. He is impressed with us now. Sweet! I wonder. Because I don't want to blow Bryce up again. I've done that already. I'm kind of over that. I believe you can get him, you can let him go in now. You choose, bruh. Fuck! Awesome, YouTube recommended me this without having to go to the chat to get the link. Sweet! Nice. Okay, so are we gonna blow Bryce up again? Because I kind of don't want to. Don't want to have to kill him again. You know, I kind of like Bryce. I mean, he resized my asshole, but that's another thing. Ugh. Sure. If he wants to live, he should notice a tripwire. Fuck off, dude. Okay, so I'm gonna go in first. I'm not gonna let him blow up because I don't want him to die. Fucking damn it, don't spoil it. Okay, now we have these choices. And since you people said it is hard. And since you said it's hard to get his good ending. I'm just like, does this matter now? How do my choices matter here? Fuck! Los Anna Adine? What? Yeah, that's what I'm currently on, yeah. Witness? Yeah, hi Chromatic, by the way. There is a message on my actual Discord server. The Witness? Oh boy. Hang on! People are saying stuff. Okay, we're gonna visit the Witness. Hello! I mean, not... Wait a minute! Okay. Oh, it's you. Can I help you? Yeah, I'm working with the police and hoped you could answer a few questions. Oh, because I responded to your call for witnesses about last night, right? Yes. Alright, what do you want to know? I forgot that that was this guy. Can you tell me what happened? Sure, I was running with an experiment in my home laboratory and was waiting for it to finish. Around 2 a.m, I suddenly heard a few bangs outside. They reminded me of small explosions. Well, gunshots. Those basically are small explosions. It sounded like they were coming from just around the corner. I see. Did nothing about this seem unusual to you? I mean, small explosions in the middle of the night, that's pretty fucking weird. Not really. I know I've caused a few similar disturbances with my experiments before. If someone else decided to take up home experimentation, they certainly have my approval. Besides, I wasn't in any position to abandon the experiment that was running at the time, or else it could have had a similar outcome. Okay, good that you didn't. Thank you. I think that will be all. No problem. By the way, are you going to meet with Lorem again anytime soon? Oh! Wait a minute! Oh, Mighty Mike! Sup, dude? Wait a minute, I know why Lorem... That makes sense now! Hang on. Here's a little theory. I know what happened. In previous routes, I have visited this guy before, and he was talking about how his roommate was missing, which is Lorem. Now, why was he missing? He was missing because he went on that treasure hunt and got trapped underneath the cabinet and drowned to death. That's pretty fucking grim, dude. What the hell? Holy shit. I mean, it's fun how that makes sense now, but still, holy shit. Oh, I don't know. Why are you asking? Oh, you've hung out with him a few times now. You see, he doesn't have many friends, and I think he's starting to like you. That's not really unusual. It's just... if something happens the next time you meet, don't be mad at him, okay? Okay. I think the fucker's got the hots for me! Oh boy! He did it, boys, he unraveled the mystery. This game's fucked up. Drowning is one of the worst deaths ever? Yes. That I have to agree with. I mean, you know, except for something like bleeding out, drowning is up there. You know, you're basically stuck just choking to death. That's really fucked up, man. It's supposed to be pretty peaceful, actually. Followed by paper cuts. Death by 1,000 paper cuts? Ugh. Okay, so what haven't I done yet? That was freezing to death? That would be pretty terrible as well. I mean, it's basically along the same lines. You're just, you know, forced to... you know, just slowly succumb to the elements. Fucking terrible, dude. Well, it's... I don't know what else to do. I mean, I've taken the PDA to the library. I've taken the banish to the facility before, so... what else am I gonna do? I mean, you panic at first, but then you kind of just pass out. I mean, it's that panic that's fucked, you know? It's just like, oh fuck, I'm gonna die. I mean, you could probably come to terms with it. I mean, I wouldn't. But, you know, it's terrible to me, dude. Well, like I said, I've already done everything here, so I mean, I just will take the banish to the facility, I don't know. I mean, I've taken the edge to Ashtree. I don't want to go with Kevin! Weird fucker. Let's just do the facility. Fuck it. Seen this before? No. Has anything changed? No, it hasn't. We keep going. Holy mother of Skip! And we have a message from Lorem. Hey, it's me. You want to meet up again? I know you're busy, but the summer festival is coming up soon. But the worst death in this game, I think people know who I'm talking about. Don't you spoil it! Don't you fucking spoil it! I will actually permaban you, okay? I am kidding, of course, but, you know. I'm not saying we should go, but we certainly could if you want to. In any case, call me back when you hear this. Well, how can I say no to that cute little fucker? Do I? Just shut up, okay? We're gonna meet with Lorem. Sod it! That must be Lorem. Hey, Hey, Lorem. So, this is where you live. You already got a glimpse when you delivered Raze's letter, remember? Yeah, but back then I didn't really notice anything. I was nervous. You are so cute! God! Kidding, not kidding. Raze, lol. Why were you nervous? Well, there was the fact that I was going to speak to a human. Plus, I didn't know if you'd actually listen to what I had to say. But then I also wondered if I was going to remember everything I wanted to tell you. Or worse, if I'd get thrown out again like when I talked to Reza. You actually talked to Reza? Well, not really. He just took the letter I had for him and closed the door. But that was before you arrived here. Do you know who sent the letter? It came through the portal, so I assume it was from a human. I see. By the way, did you hear about Ipsum? Apparently he's become a witness for a murder case. Yeah, I actually took a statement about that not too long ago. Really? Oh, does this mean that this has something to do with Raze's disappearance? This fucker is so adorable! I just want to hug him and hold him and call him cute and like pinch his fucking... pinch his cute little cheeks! And scratch him behind the ear, Oh, if I hear this fucker purring, I'm just gonna have a heart attack. Well, there's really no use denying it by this point. How long have you been helping the police anyway? Well, since the day of my arrival, really. Oh, wow. I guess that explains why you've been so busy. I imagine you can't talk about it, though. Well, I don't really care anymore. Besides, I think it has become common knowledge by this point. You're trying to find Reza, right? Wasn't he your friend? I'm not sure if I'd call him that. Still, he was supposed to be your partner in this, and now he's just gone. Well, I'm more worried about what he's doing now. Even if we find him, this may put our diplomatic relationship in peril. I guess I shouldn't talk about stuff like that. Why not? Well, it's no use worrying about things that I can't change. Right, just focus on the things you can. That's my philosophy. God, it's like we are the same person, Lorem. Ugh. You know, it's a bit of a shame you didn't want to go to the festival. Well, I already had my fair share of adventure the last time we met. Besides, I should probably lay low for now. You're right, the crowds would probably go crazy if they saw you. We could still watch the big fireworks show together, though. We wouldn't even need to go to the festival grounds to do that. Sure, if you like. It only takes place at the end of the festival, though. When's that? A few days from now. He's too cute for me to handle. Looks like it. Well, you've been here a few minutes and already want to schedule our next get-together? Get-together? That's an odd way of phrasing it. Would you prefer if I called it a date? I don't know. Oh, he's cute. He's cute. Oh, God. It just seems a bit odd to me, considering this all started with me begging you to meet me so I could draw pictures of you. Well, we did that, and then we went treasure hunting, which was your way of saying thanks. What would you call what we're doing here now, then? Dinner. I invited you for dinner. I'm not seeing anything to eat here, though. I mean, you can eat my dick, if you catch my drift. Right, that's because I wasn't sure about what's in the kitchen. I also don't know what you like, so let's just order something. There are a few places nearby. Do you have anything in mind? I'm not really in the mood to try something new. Sure, how about pizza? Pizza? Pizza is always the right answer, okay? Pizza... literally always the right answer. 100%. Bless pure and innocent Dirk, Metalcore. Sounds good. Alright, let's just call Pentolis then. I don't trust those fuckers. Well, they already let us down with the treasure hunt. Why do you think this will be different? They're the closest, and I haven't ordered from them in ages. Maybe for good reason. If they can't even get the treasure hunt right, I don't want to know what they do to their pizzas. It's just a pizza, Metalcore. How bad could it be? Listen here, you little shit. Making pizzas is an art, okay? They need just the right amount of dough, the right amount of tomato sauce, and just the right amount of other ingredients sprinkled on top. That is a motherfucking art form, okay? Don't underestimate pizza making, okay? You little shit. People are now gonna freak the fuck out because I'm swearing at the guy. Don't worry, I'm joking! Alright, if you want the voucher for Pentolis, go ahead. Lorem took the sphere from its base and started to manipulate its interface with his fingers. What are you doing? Looking up the menu. I thought using Ipsum Sphere was only for emergencies. A motherfucking skill? Yeah. Well, he went into my room when he is looking for the sphere, and he isn't allowed to do that unless it's an emergency. That's the least he can do, considering you found it for him. Alright. If you don't want pizza, I can just put it back and we can order something else. Oh, you already touched the sphere. It's too late to put it back now. If you say so. Not true, I nuke my pizzas. You uncultured fucking swine. Let's see. Even their smallest pizza is going to be pretty big for me. Oh, we could share one. Sure, what toppings would you like? I think I'll go with salad. Salad pizza? Are you joking? Pizza can be extremely varied as well. Pizza burger, pizza pasta, pasta pizza. Oh god, stop. You're making me hungry. Ah, sure. Are you sure? Let me see what else they have. Here's the menu. What would you like on your half? I mean, salad pizza sounds interesting. Never had it before. Really? Alright. And it's done. The order's been placed. For the next 30 minutes, Lorem showed me many of the other and less useful features of the Ixamon Sphere. He made it levitate, showed me a primitive looking website, and even used it as a voice modulator. Pizza taco? Stop! You're making me hungry! Stop! Jesus. I'll get it. Lorem got up and walked to the door. From my place on the couch, I couldn't see anything, but I heard a bit of talking before he returned to me carrying the square box. Well, the flyer who just delivered this, I actually know her. I guess it's not unusual for you to know each other. Your jobs are pretty similar. Mac and cheese pizza? Stop! My hunger! Please! Mercy! I suppose. Some things never change in this town. Lorem opened the box and showed me the pizza we had ordered. Memories of days gone by raced through my head. Alright, let's get this party started. Don't we need more people for a party? With pizza, anything's a party. Fucking amen to you, Lorem! Amen! Yo, you lovely little bugger. Guys, please, I'm too hungry for this. Exactly, stop! I feel like I haven't had a pizza like this in ages. What are you waiting for, then? I took one of the slices. On its surface, there was an obvious layer of grease that was sure to stain anything it came in contact with. Nom! What do you think? It's been way too long. A female flyer that delivers food? I mean, that can only be one person. You know, our yellow bat. You know, the color that my bed is right now. Adine. It's been way too long. Guess you don't mind that we got Pentolis now, huh? With these words, he grabbed one of the slices on his half and bit into it. After chewing a few times, his expression suddenly twisted into a scowl. Something wrong? Now I remember why I haven't ordered from Pentolis in a while. Their pizza sucks. I don't like saying this, but I fucking said so! You're eating pizza right now? Well, you could just go fuck yourself and the pizza you're eating, okay? That's not that bad. Oh, maybe you just haven't had a good pizza to compare it to. Hey, it's still better than nothing. I suppose. By the way, how's your game coming along? I don't know. I feel like I've hit a wall. Why's that? Maybe I got in over my head, you know? I mean, that's very common, actually. The more progress I make, the more comes apparent that I'll need a lot more help than I thought. So far, you're the only one who's been working on this, right? Yep, but I'm starting to realize that it won't work out if I continue like this. Why not? It would never be done. Or if it was, it would be very... It told you to play with your food, runs. I didn't miss it. Oh boy. It would be very different from what I'd like it to be, so something needs to change. I suppose I'm just worried, because once you start involving other people, things get a lot more complicated. How so? Well, I've always been the odd one out, so I'm not sure how well I could work with a team. You have to find people, work out how to pay them, and how to divide the work. Yeah, I know how that feels, Lorem. I could send you a pic of it on Skype if you want. No, go fuck yourself. You're not gonna send me a picture of your pizza. Fuck you. You're gonna make me even more hungry. I guess I'm just starting to realize what kind of investment this would actually be. Oh, you sounded a lot more optimistic the last time we talked about this. Yeah, it's all fun and games when you're just thinking about ideas that you could turn into a game. But once you actually start working on it, it's a completely different story. At some point, it just becomes another job. Isn't that what you expected? Of course it is. I knew it would be a lot of work, but I guess I'm just not sure if it's all worth it. Well, that depends on why you're making it in the first place. Last time you said that you hadn't... I bet I will. Last time you said that you had nothing to lose either way. Well, maybe I was wrong about that. I do have something to lose. What's that? Myself? Ooh. Ooh. Oh. Lorem. The feels, bro. Holy shit. That's deep, by the way. Holy shit. I'm not sure if I'm ready to do what is necessary to finish what I started. Well, if you think about it, what is the worst that could happen? Investing a lot of time and money, only to end up with nothing in the end? I could end up disappointing those who played the game, those who collaborated with me, and lastly, myself. There is nothing worse than disappointing yourself. I know all about that. That's what you're worried about? He really delivered feels? Yeah, he did. It's getting hot in here. Well, that's what being a creator is like. If you put tons of work and effort into something, you want people to like it, right? If that's not what's going to happen, why do it in the first place? You see, that is where you and I differ. The thing is, I am a creator as well. I make YouTube videos. I do live streams. I'm gonna do compilations, but I mean... You know, I work on, you know, thumbnails and other art for other things. You know, I'm pretty decent at Photoshop. And the thing is, I don't do this to entertain others. I mean, it is one of my side objectives, of course. You know, if I can entertain a few fuckers while I'm doing this thing, sure, fine. I'll take it. But that's not the reason why I'm doing it. Which is why I can live stream in front of no viewers and still have fun doing it. Because I am just working on myself, you know, I want to get better at being a little bit more impulsive, you know, doing, becoming better at improvising, you know, learning how to do commentary, you know, get a bit more control of my voice, etc., etc. Those are the things I want to work on, and something like this is the perfect way of doing that. And if some people want to watch me do it, fine. That's great. Fun. The more the merrier, right? But I mean, if I have to do it all by myself, I mean, when I'm playing games by myself, I talk to myself all the time. Just to see, you know, what happens. See if I can, you know, come up with some funny stuff to say while I do it. I mean, the difference is, now I don't sit alone, but I broadcast it to the internet. And, you know, it allows people to watch with me. So, that is where he and I differ, I suppose. You know, I'm not necessarily doing it just to entertain people. I'm doing it to develop myself and because I think it's fun to do. Which is, again, why I can broadcast to no people at all. And I would still be fine doing it. Because, well, hey, it's something I enjoy doing. You know, having to scroll through hours of footage, you know, of these live streams, I have already had around 12 hours of it. I need to sift through all that. But it's fun just watching back the way I responded. The things that I've said, the jokes that I made. Now I'm like, oh hey, I could have said something else here. Or, hey, that was actually a really cool thing that I did there. I should do that more often. So that is why I enjoy doing this, because I can see how I've been at a certain point and how that compares to the way that I am now. And that is the amazing thing about it. So that is where he and I differ. I've gone off on a massive tangent, holy shit. I just basically life lessons with metalcore in today's episode, me as a creator and as how I differ. Yeah, that is, I mean, I just wanted to go off on that tangent, man. Well, but you're not doing this for other people, are you? It's your game and your idea, after all. Three deep, five me. But, you know, that, like I said, you know, if it doesn't come from a genuine place as the way I do it, you know, would it really be worth watching? It was from the heart? Yeah. Right, but... Well, you're not trying to cater to someone else, so what other people think is not important. Besides, what they think is outside of your control anyway. Just look at what happened with Pantoli's. Why do you think their pizza sucks? Well, they probably cut a lot of corners during production and with the ingredients. They value quantity over quality and are only trying to get as many pizzas out as possible to satisfy demand. They are cheap and the pizza tastes like it. Okay, but they are still in business, so this must be working out for them somehow. Even if you don't like it, they are offering something other people will clearly want. They probably don't give a damn about whether or not you like their pizza. I'm sure they don't. Yeah, that is exactly why their pizza fucking blows. They just give people what they want, and that's why they stay in business. Are you saying that I won't be successful if I don't cater to others? No, I'm saying that unless being successful is the goal, you don't need to cater to anyone else. Amen, brothers. Amen. Holy shit. Because if you did, you would end up like Pantoli's, and you would really lose yourself. I guess you have a point. This must be that slice of life aspect of the game? Yeah. So what if other people like their greasy pizzas? That's not what you want to do. Certainly not. You said yourself that your philosophy is to focus on the things that you can change. So what are your options here? A wise person once said, do or do not. There is no try. That's Yoda, right? Not doing this has never been an option for me. Then you make the most of it and nothing else matters. I think you're right. I should just focus on getting things done as best as I can. Who knows? Maybe you're wrong around Pantoli's. Maybe they're actually a big family restaurant with a rich tradition and history. And that's why people like them. No, I think it's just because they have cheap pizzas. Aw, now he's sad. Anyway, there's a good reason for my anxiety. I usually keep to myself, and that's always how I've worked best. Yeah, I can relate. I can really relate. If there's one thing that life has taught me, it's that people fear what they don't know. Yeah. I have been that way for a long time. You know, I wasn't born with very many social skills, so I've had to learn all of it. You know, I have Asperger's syndrome. I mean, a rather light form of it, but it was still rather noticeable during my younger years. And I mean, if you look at me now, you know, I am talking without problem. You know, I can speak in front of a camera. You know, where people who talk to me on a regular basis, they will say, hey, I don't even fucking notice it. I'm actually a really pleasant person to be around. So, yeah, I've had to learn that. We can all relate to the small dragon. Yeah. I guess that's an odd thing to say when humans are worshipped by many. Most of them don't actually know any humans. Not like I know you. Maybe I should rephrase that. People are afraid of what they don't understand. Exactly. I was bullied a lot when I was a kid. Lorem, stop making me relate to you! It's like I'm looking at a mirror image of myself. Stop it! You know, it can be pretty tough when you're growing up and all the other kids are always bigger than you are. Lorem, stop! You're making me think that you are just me! Quit it! Luckily, that was never a big problem for me. As even in kindergarten, we get told to not make fun of our differences because of how different our species are. It's just odd for us that for a society that celebrates our differences, there are still things that are too different even for them. Yeah, I don't think that will ever change, really. When I grew up and went to college, I thought that people would know better than to continue doing those horrible things. But I was ultimately proven wrong. Lorem is a mirror of ourselves. Guess the kind of people that play this game, at least. Their bodies may have been those of adults, but their hearts had stayed in the same place they were a decade before. And see, that's where we differ. At least, somewhat. Working on my own has helped, but that is treating the symptom, not the cause of the problem. I can't always just run away, and I'll have to step into the limelight and brave the storm again if I want to finish this game. There's something about me that you don't know. Oh, here we go. Oh, boy. Well, in a way, I owe it to you to tell you. Because you're going to find out sooner or later anyway. And when it happens, it should be on my own terms rather than someone else's. What is it? Oh, now I'm nervous, dude. Like, what could there be that this little dragon is like, okay, you can't tell. I'm a hermaphrodite. Ah. I see. I was born with both sets of sex organs. And before you ask, that is not something that is all common in any of our dragon species. In the eyes of some, that makes me a freak of nature. Something that needs fixing or shouldn't exist in the first place. Get out! Oh, that would be such a dick move. It's like, okay, I was born with both sets of genitals, and you're just like, get the fuck out. Fuck you, get out. Smooch him? Ugh. Protect him. Yeah, I mean, I want to, dude. I really like this guy. I mean, I have a feeling this is like the obvious thing to say, but will not lead to his good end. But I'm not sure if this is either. I mean, the get out is not going to do anything anyway. That is going to lead to his bad end, 100%. And now you know why I said do lorem. Yeah. Hell hit it both ways? You can always experiment with each other in some very, interesting ways. Lorem is Lord of Waifu? Let's just say I don't mind. You don't? Sure, some people may think that it's odd, but I don't really care. It's just another part of who you are. Follow your heart? Ugh. Thank you. That's such a big relief. Lude! You know, it's not always the bullies who go after me once they know. Too often, it's also been the people who I thought were my friends. And you know, that is the one that hurts the most. Like, the people you thought you could trust, betraying that. That is the hardest thing on the soul. If that happens. That will hit you the hardest, 100%. So, whenever I meet another person, I have to prepare myself for this conversation, not knowing whether they will suddenly turn against me when they find out. Don't worry about getting good or bad ends. Yeah, I guess. I shouldn't do that. Poor little Derg. And the reactions can be very different. Some get angry or make fun of me. Others feel betrayed and don't want to have anything to do with me anymore. And see, that is so strange to me. You know, just things like that, that they can't even do anything about, you know? Are you really going to... You know, are you really going to put that against them? Are you really? Because to me, that is one of the highest forms of scumfuckery that you can do. Is taking someone by something that he cannot change. That he was born with. Or that he was, you know, put up with, you know, something like, you know, burn scars or something. There is nothing you can fucking do about that. So why go for that? Why go for the low-hanging fruit? Come on. Be a bit of a man, at least. I'm sorry, that just pisses me off in a lot of ways, okay? I feel very strongly about that. By now, I think I've seen it all. I'm so glad that you're not like them, but it's always a gamble. Maybe the next person I tell is going to become violent. How can I put myself out there when this could happen wherever I go? You know what I mean? What would people do when they find out about me and my game? I just don't know. That's what I'm worried about. I only wish there was a place where I could be safe from all of that. Where it just wouldn't matter that this is who I am. Truer words have never been said. If someone like you, someone with a place of authority, said something, maybe that could change things. I know you can't interfere with our politics, though. You're an ambassador. Doesn't mean I don't have hope that something like that will happen one day. I should probably go now. It's getting late. No, listen here, you little guy there. You're going to stay here, and I'm going to smooch you to death, 100%. I'm going to show you the appreciation that you have earned, my friend. Because living like that is hard. I know how it feels. You know, it's not easy. And you know, sometimes just having that one person that doesn't care and that shows you appreciation for who you truly are. Hell, that could be the difference between life and death, you know? Whether someone wants to take their life or not. Believe me, I know. Smooch him. Oh, you've made me feel a lot better, though. You told me not to worry about the future, and maybe you're right. Sure, there is still a lot of work ahead, but maybe it's not as hopeless as I thought. It never is. I mean, all you can ever really do is, you know, continue working on yourself and become the best that you can possibly be. And, well, as much as it shames me to say it, I still have quite a bit to learn and do with that as well, but that is something I have actually started to realize recently. which is what I am going to work on, especially these upcoming few weeks and hopefully beyond that. You know, me trimming off my beard, my goatee, that was the first step. And hopefully there will be many more to come. So, in that way, me and Lorem, we are not so different from each other. Hey, do you still want to see the fireworks show together? Sure. Alright, just give me a call in a few days so we can discuss the details. I'll do that. Right, I'll see you then. See ya. No, Heaven, stay here! Now! God damn it. I wanted him to stay! God, you know what the thing is? And I'm crying? But you know, the thing is that this hits me on a really personal level. Night Sky's crying. Aww. Come here, I'll hug you. But you know, like I said, you know, this hits me on a personal level because I have gone through this exact same thing. So I can really relate to this. Well, we're gonna get some rest again. You decided not to meet anywhere or investigate for the 10th time. Who cares? Because I'm fucking lazy. Oh, and it didn't show it. Well, I got the achievement anyway. Fucking lazy! Dun-dun-dun-dun. Duty, Chapter 5. And there's Miss, and there's Sebastian. Hugs for everyone who needs him. Not yet. Not yet. Good morning, sweet cheeks. Who shall I bring? Well, of course I'm gonna fucking take Lorem. Duh. Yo, Lorem. Come here, you big goof. After a few minutes of walking, I arrived at a rather empty-looking area near the edge of town. I am really kind of scared for what's to come, to be quite honest. Check status of everyone. He's impressed, he's neutral, these two are dead. I mean, we know what happened to Anna, and we know what happened to Sebas. Hey, Lorem. Hey, Metalcore. You're right. This would be much better than mingling with the crowds. I can do it without all the extra noise and screaming. Yeah. So, what are we going to do now? Wait. I think it's starting. Look. We were quiet as we waited, and the stillness of the night enveloped us. Soon I heard the sound of the first rocket making its way into the night sky, after which it exploded in a pattern of colors. More rockets followed, their thunderous noise echoing throughout the land. That's a Dean? Oh, wait. Shut up. Suddenly, a terrible realization hit me. Fireworks. Wrist deserted. Would also any gunshots. Been prepared by a serious person. He was gonna make his getaway. Lorem, I think we need to go. Now. What's going on? I know where Reza is. Really? We need to stop him. What do you think I can do? He's twice as big as I am, and let's not forget about his weapon. I can try to hold him off. You go and get help. Alright. Where is he anyway? The underground building. Let's go. Shit. I am very scared for what's about to happen, like I said. Still turned off and hasn't been used. He's still around. There we have a very deceased Sebastian. Which makes me sad every time I look at him. And in we go. Here he is. Yeah, it wants to get out. Like, nope. Feels a lot of them. Shit. Okay. Answer questions. Dead Seb, Adine, and Anna. Wait, how did Adine die? Wait, don't no, don't answer that. No! Shh. You fucking keep quiet about that, okay? Okay, realize we're in the past. We recently found out. Seemed obvious. Let me tab. Okay, what did he say? I mean, what are you going to do? You can't stop me now, anyway. Maybe I can. Suddenly, Maverick and Lorem appeared next to me. Why Lorem? Lorem, what are you doing? Lorem, no. No, 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 no. Where's Bryce? Bryce, you fuck. Shit. Oh, I planned this apparently. Traitor. Fuck, no, dude. You just gotta put two and two together, yeah, and you'll find out how you did a route. Shit. Oh wait, she did the show, and then she. Okay. Well, that's really fucking sad. No, I don't want to do this. I mean, you know, Maverick can take a few bullets. You know, that fucker is like a small car. But Lorem, he is smaller than me. You know, he takes a bullet, he's dead. Fuck. Oh man, I don't want to do that. But I have to. Yep. Wow, that's dark. Metalcore Sherlock confirmed. This is one that I actually feel anxious about. Hesitation, same as I did and still do. I actually don't want to do this. Fuck it, dude. I have to. He pulled out his gun, not sure which one of us he should be aiming at. Just let me go and I'll forget this thing ever happened. I've got 6 bullets for 3 people. Do you really think you can do that, Reza? Do you really think this is worth risking your life for? And then this. Old fucking building came from a time they belong to humanity. Then the administrator comes out. Then she gets shot and... Bang! So many feels. But Maverick and Lorem started charging? Lorem does? Are you joking? I know what's about to happen. At least I think I do. Fuck! Okay. Let's just get this over with. Razor was quick with his aim and shot at Maverick until he went down. Wait, he took more bullets! So... Those were three... Were those 3 or 4 shots? Fuck. Still, can he count to 6 today? Shut the fuck up! I think those were 3 shots. The feels, okay? Lorem took flight with a few beats of their wings. Oh, of course, because he's technically both he and she. about to collide with Reza, but at the last moment, Reza got out of the way and hit Lorne with a well-aimed kick.
Oh, you... Okay, you have just done it. In an instant, Reza was aiming at me, and I quickly dove behind the box with the generator for cover, just before he pulled the trigger. Wait, so those were four shots? Now I'm confused. So, if he has fired five times, he is now, after this shot, he is out. Yeah, he's out. While I was unharmed, a loud hiss suddenly started emanating from the box. I knew what was going to happen and quickly started running towards the exit. But Lorne, though! No! Just as I reached the outside, the explosion battered my ears and the shockwave sent me flying briefly before I collided roughly with the ground. My vision blurred instantly and all control left my body as I slowly closed my eyes. No, don't you tell me that I'm gonna pass out here! No! Because Lauren's gonna die in there! F? Yeah, man, F to pay respects, I guess, if I'm gonna do this. No! What?! I awoke to the sight of Reza aiming his gun at me. This motherfucker got out?! He was behind that thing! Dude, if Lorm is dead, you do not want to know the things that I am going to do to this guy. You do not want to know. Also, holy shit, a lot of people joined. What the heck did you do to the portal? What are you talking about? I didn't do anything. Why can't I use it then? And what happened to the coordinates? The dragons don't know that much about the portal, so it must have been you or that girl. You better give me something, or else I have no reason to let you live. It was her. Steam, I know. Who is she? I don't know. They must have sent her through after you. The only question is, why? Well, actually, they didn't. That's the thing you don't know. Well, you were the one who suddenly vanished. Maybe that's why they sent her. I had my plan and humanity was fine with it. You must have told them something that changed their minds. I haven't been in contact with them since the day I arrived here. I've got nothing to do with her. I just wanted a diplomatic solution. Forehead? That was the fucking plan. You weren't supposed to know anything about what I was doing. If humanity knew, why would they send her then? That's what I've been asking myself. It doesn't make any sense. It doesn't really matter anyway. She's the only one who knows how to use the portal again, and now that you've killed her, we're both stuck here. You've got something to do with this, or else you wouldn't be so fucking smug about it. No, I just like seeing you fail. Stop denying it! You're going to fix this right now, or I'll find ways to make you talk. Oh, listen here, motherfucker. I know some things, okay? I'm a biologist. I know all the ways your nerves go. I know all your tendons, how your whole body works together. And do you think I won't do anything with that knowledge, you know? I know where I need to press to make it hurt. I know what to slice to make sure you can't move. So do you really think you would want to mess with me? Because like I said, I know how you work. And I know how to make you stop ticking. Which isn't that hard anyway, but... Nothing you can do or say will change what's coming now. What's that? Stop spamming. Stop. I'm gonna rip your dick off? Yeah, pretty much. Oh, are we being raided? Well, whatever. You know, Night Sky, if they keep spamming, ban them. Or time them out. Turn around. Reza glanced back over his shoulder just in time to see Maverick running towards him. Be afraid of Metalcore? Oh yeah. He turned around, aiming his gun in Maverick's direction. Before he could fire, I grabbed his hand in an attempt to disarm him. But in the scuffle, a shot went off and I suddenly found myself in a world of pain. I collapsed to the ground still holding the gun. Shit. And he pounced and raises down. What are you going to do now, Razor? Not so strong anymore without your weapon, huh? Om nom nom nom! No, am I gonna die now? Oh, fuck. The voice has faded as I watch the sky. Shit. My vision turned red, making it look as if the stars were bathing in a sea of blood. I resigned to my fate as I closed my eyes. I mean, I know we're not gonna die, but still. Fuck! Wait, how about Lorem? Razor was apprehended and taken to jail. As communication between our worlds was no longer possible, humanity never learned of our fate in this timeline. They had decided that if our visit did not yield any results, they would no longer try their luck with the portal, and instead use their remaining energy to hold off as long as they still could. It was an uphill battle that was eventually lost when the city ran out of resources and fell. Razor warned the dragons of the comet and its danger, but without the generators from the underground building, their plan to redirect it ultimately failed. So, what about me? No, did he die? No, dude, come on. Come on, dude. I know the world isn't fair, but come on! Come on, he was just about to get his shit together. He was happy again. Come on, dude. He was gonna make that game and everything. Fuck, dude. Come on. That's... No, dude. That's not fair. Come on. So I died. And I assume Lorem died as well, because he probably drowned. Come on, dude. Come on. You have seen Lorem's bad ending? I mean, that makes sense, but... still. Fuck. And I thought I was doing well. I guess I wasn't. Tears? A little bit. I mean, they're not very visible, but... like I said, this is the one that made my art ache the most. Because, like I said, this guy has been put down all his fucking life. And now he's just dead, taken away. At just the fucking turning point. Where he's like, you know what? I'm gonna fucking do something about this. You know, instead of walking in the darkness all alone, let's step out into the limelight. I mean, that's just... that's just not fair. No, that's... no, I can see it as an injustice, but... you know, there's nothing you're gonna do about it. And that's the problem. You know, you can't do anything about it. You know, you can stomp your feet on the ground as much as you want.
There is nothing that will stop time from ticking, make time go backwards. You know, what happens, happens, and you need to live with it. But like I said, I didn't want this to end that way. You know, only seeing him, you know, the last thing that I see of the fucker is just him crumpled on the ground, being kicked by Reza. And, you know, being blown up and, well, drowning. I mean, I don't know if he got knocked out or not, if he actually experienced it. I mean, for his soul, I hope he didn't. As you know, that would actually bring, you know, the tiniest bit of solace that he at least died without knowing it. You know, blacking out after that, being knocked out by the explosion, and, you know, just passing away in your sleep. No, that is the only thing about this part that I can consider, you know, somewhat justice, I guess. Maverick didn't survive at the end, he died with the comets. I mean, we all died. Pretty much in this playthrough, you know, I died. They didn't stop the comet, so everyone's dead. And you know, this is exactly why I want to get my shit together. Especially now. Because, you know, you don't know what's going to happen. You know, perhaps, you know, when I go to work on a Saturday, you know, I'm, you know, on my bike in traffic, I get taken out by a car or something, and, well, you know, I get paralyzed from the waist down, or I just, you know, I die, I go into a coma, never to wake up again. You know, it's, life's too short for that stuff, you know? If you want to do something, do it now. Because you never know what tomorrow may bring. And perhaps once you do truly decide to try, oh, it may already be too late. Like with Lorem. And like I said, that's just the greatest injustice about this route. Because he wanted to try. Because I could see that in him, you know? Just the way he talked, his general mood, his motivations. Oh, you knew the fucker wanted to go for it. You know, and with that attitude, you can conquer the fucking world. But unfortunately, his flame was sniffed out. Right at the turning point. Definitely tears. Yeah, dude, I am crying. I am 100% crying. But you know, that's the sad part about it, because like I said, this is the same situation that I'm going through, you know? I've always walked alone. He sounded so genuine, yeah. And I mean, I've walked alone for a long time. You know, always walking the path of the darkness, you know, walking during the night. And I really do enjoy walking during the night because, you know, there's no one else around. You know, I can be alone and just, you know, the world is calm for a bit. And, you know, with that, you just forget to step out into the light every so often. Because beyond the world of the darkness is also a, you know, a whole nother world where most people will reside. And that's why I'm glad that I found this game and that we started this community over it. Because, well, you guys are helping me step out into the light a bit again.
You know, I haven't had any, you know, sort of personal social contact for, well, months now. You know, didn't have a reason to. And, you know, I have to say this is the happiest I've also been for a long time. And like I said, I figured some things out, and I'm gonna work more on myself now. Just like Lorem. And all I can do now is hope that I'm not too late. That once I'm trying, I find something out that will, well, snuff my light out, or that will prevent me from doing so. But no, it was metalcore. And you know, I just, like I said, I hope it's not too late. I'm gonna take control back. And I'm gonna fucking make myself into what I want to be. And to be able to say that if I die on this very moment, I'll be satisfied. You know, I will be capable of saying I'm glad what I did. I'm both glad with what I did, and I can be proud of what I've become. Because I've taken all the easy things, you know, my choice in music, my college, you know, my way of thinking, you know, that's all the easy stuff for me. But, you know, stuff like my physical body, that's something I've just ignored all this time. And same thing with, you know, sort of taking control of my life. I've never really done it, always just, you know, sort of going with the flow, taking the bare minimum for where I can say, you know, I'm satisfied with it. So yeah, I'm gonna work on that. And it's funny how we get onto Lorem's route now. Because it just reminds me of myself so much. yeah, he did open the floodgates. He definitely did. And that's what I've been waiting for from this game. You know, the other ones were really sad. You know, but they haven't given me the emotional hit that I wanted it to give me. You know, I've had high expectations of this game. You know, everyone's, you know, praising it out of high heavens. Can someone silence Bojo real quick? We need like a big group hug. Yeah, we do. But like I said, this also really, really motivates me to start doing that. Because this just reminds me how quickly everything could change. Now once again, in, you know, just like that, you know, human life is fragile, you know, just, and it's gone. You know, snuffed out like a candle. Okay, Bojo, I'm tempted to ban you right now. Timed out. Okay, that at the very least. I'm very tempted to ban the guy right now. Okay. Wow. That was quite the experience. Let me see. Do we have a gallery entry? We don't. We only have this guy right here. I relate so much. How do I get there? I honestly don't know what I want out of my life to truly go for. I just want undefined happiness. Not sure what I want or what I should be doing with myself, unlike Lorem. Go out and try something. Just, you know, if you want, make a list. Make a list of, like, things you can do. And just, you know, go, okay, I'm gonna try this. I'm gonna try that. Because that's what I'm doing right now. Because I,
in the last period of this college year, you know, we sort of get these extra classes that you can do, which may have nothing to do with the course you're currently doing. And this last period, I'm actually going to do, what's it called? It's like theater. Though, just to see what it's like, you know, acting has always really interested me, you know. I think it can improve upon me as a content creator. And like I said, you know, I've always been very interested in that. Just to see, okay, you know, how does that work, you know, and maybe I'll think it's fun. So, that's something I'm trying. So just do something like that. Just, you know, take something, even if that's something where you're like, okay, I would probably never like that, because who the fuck knows? Maybe you do really like it. And if you've tried it and you like it, you'll be glad that you did. You know, that's how I end up with games like these. You know, that's how I ended up in the Brony community. That's how I ended up here. That's like, okay, I'm not sure, like, you know, not sure if I wanted to do it, like, you know, whatever. Thought I wanted to work on computers, so I spent a lot of time learning that, then went to college for computers, got a job at Microsoft, and hated it. Realized I didn't want to work on computers, so I don't know what to do now. Like I said, pick something at random. That is really the only advice I can give, because, well, I don't know you. I don't know what other things you like. Just, your best guess is, well, guessing, I suppose. Or at least that's my way of looking at it. I think I'm gonna need a timeout real quick. I am gonna need some time to process all that. Yeah, I'm glad that I found this game in you guys. I truly do, and I truly appreciate you being here for me, you know, joining me on going through this game, you know, laughing with me, crying with me, joking about me. You know, I really appreciate that from the bottom of my heart. Thank you, guys. So, now that we're done going through all that, well, I have nothing really else that I want to add at the moment, you know, thank you all so much for watching. Like I said, I truly appreciate it. I happened to find this at random, turned on your stream as background noise while I was playing Final Fantasy XIV, and then all this hit. Go get the bear you were saving. I think Lorem deserves that. Yeah, hang on. Let me grab that beer for you guys. I think we can have a toast to him. Okay, so what I want you guys to do is I want you to go grab something to chug, whatever, and I want you guys to drink with me, okay? We are all gonna go and chug whatever the fuck it is. I got a beer right here. Let me see, someone's got a whiskey, gonna get a Strongbow, Dr. Pepper, I mean. We are going to chug something down for this guy. We are going to drink to this glorious bastard. Because this fucker went out in a blaze. Like, you know, he could have stayed back. You know, stayed outside, he'll be safe. But, you know, this fucker charged straight into a guy that is bigger and stronger than himself with a deadly weapon that can basically kill you in an instant. He charged without hesitation. This glorious bastard should be an example for all of us. because he charged into there without thinking, without hesitation. He was like, fuck it, I am going. I am doing this. I got some bleach. Okay, yeah, you're getting banned. Actually, no, I'm going to put you in timeout. You fuck. These guys are assholes, honestly. Fuck off. Not the time. Let me just put it that way. I don't drink, but I got water for this then? Sure. That works. Okay, so I'm going to wait until everyone's here. Just tell me when you guys are ready. Okay, we're going to wait real quick until everyone's back, and then we're going to chug this down. And I've seen every ending this game has, but it's far more emotional right now. He's ready. Mighty Mike's ready. Joe Shark's ready. Night Sky's ready. Geth is ready. Yeah, this was much more emotional than on my own. Yeah, we're going to try for a good ending, of course. Okay. It's up. Okay, I'm going to count down. And then we're going to drink, okay? Okay, we're going to chug this, okay? 3, 2, 1, cheers. I got some on my head. Fuck. Woo. Yeah, Kaiken, you're banned. Let me see. Yeah, you're getting blocked. cheers. Saw that? Check the glass bottle of honey strongbow. Nice, dude. So many trolls with no hearts, seriously? Yeah. Let me go back to that other guy. I'll ban him as well. Duckmaster Bob. Blocked. Bojo. Blocked. There we go. Just gotta, you know... I'd have lost a drinking contest with Bryce. Yeah, dude, same here. I'm already feeling it, so I'm getting a little bit tipsy, but it's fine. All right, so yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. Thanks for going through this with me, because honestly, you know, I mean, I didn't think anyone would even watch this. You know, I just did it to, you know, to entertain Night Sky so he can, you know, watch with me as I play through it. Alright, so, thank you all so much for watching. Go to the Discord link in the description. There is a link to both this game and the our own personal Discord server, the unofficial Discord server for the game, where we all hang out every day, pretty much. Press the subscribe button, like, favorite, comment, etc., etc. And, yeah, I will, can we do Anna for the next one? Sure, I will do Anna. So we're going to do Anna tomorrow, same time, 8 p.m. GMT plus 1, Central European time. Then we're going to do Anna, and, A German beer liver engaged. So we're gonna do that. And yeah, we're gonna stream at the same time. It'll be announced on the Discord server. It will be announced on my personal Discord server, which is also down in the description. And in the end, I decided to let you do the playthrough, and I pretty much do nothing anymore. I mean, that's fine, dude. I don't care. NSPLs, regardless of ending. Oh god, I think I'm gonna have to get more beer tomorrow. If that's gonna be the way, oh boy. But like I said, do all that stuff, and yeah, thank y'all fuckers so much for watching, and I will see you guys tomorrow in the next stream. Peace.